in the Northwest and second in the West. Good evening and welcome to GM Place. My name is Dan Murphy. 5 days ago, the Canucks trailed the Avs by 1 point in the Northwest, then battled Colorado to a 5-5 tie. Since then, each team has played 3 games. They've won one, lost one, and tied one. So the Canucks are still 1 point back of the Avalanche in the West. Not only is this for tops, but in the Northwest, but it's for second in the West. And the Wings are going to pick up at least 1 point tonight. If you're wondering who has a tougher remaining schedule, Vancouver, 7 games left against playoff teams. Colorado, 8, including 2 against Detroit. Game's always exciting between the Canucks and Avalanche. And one reason why is that both have defensemen that love to jump up into the play. And few have been more active lately than Matias Olin. Olin has 4 goals in the Canucks' last 5 games. In that span, he's averaged 3 shots per game. You know what? He knows his main job is keeping the puck out of the Canucks' net. And tonight, he'll be busy trying to take on the trio of Joe Sakic, Milan Hayduk, and Alex Tonga. Just in case you were wondering, the Canucks and Avs have 2 of the top defensive units in the entire NHL. For more on that, let's go upstairs now to Jim Houston and Ryan Walter.
Thank you, Murph. Nice to have Ryan with us tonight as John joins the gossip people in Toronto for trading deadline, and will be back with us in the next game. You know, the defense, as Dan Murphy touched on, really does like to get up in the play tonight. All of the games, 74 goals, 288 points between these two defensive units, and even some unlikely characters like the ever-improving Brian Allen are joining that defensive rush.
Well, and I think it's an indication of the whole sort of way the Vancouver Canucks want to generate offense. Watch Allen here in Columbus. This is a great example of it. Marcus Naslund will move the puck. Brian Allen will emerge in front of the net there to create a little time and space for Marcus Naslund.
And on the other end, Joe Sakic doesn't need a lot of help, but he loves the help he's getting from John Michael Lyles, who's a newcomer who's taken over as the number 3 man on defense for the Colorado Avalanche and makes great passes like he did on that one. And that was in a great game that Joe Sakic had last week against the Vancouver Canucks. He is excellent when the chips are down and excellent in games here.
Look at the release, Jim. I think the key thing, if you're watching tonight's game at home with us, is to watch the release of Joe Sakic. It's as good as any wrist shot release in the league right now.
Joe had 3 goals last week in the 5-5 tie, and in that game, his line mate Alex Tanguay had 5 points. Burnaby Joe loves to play here, and you know he'll be front and center for the Avalanche as they take on the Vancouver Canucks in the final game of their season series. It's game number 6, Colorado-Vancouver on Sportsnet next.
Molson Canadian Canucks Hockey on Sportsnet Pacific. Brought to you by Molson Canadian. It's a Canadian game. And by Subway. Eat fresh. Hazel May, weekday mornings on Sportsnet News.
For the first time ever, the United States has become the first nation to walk on the moon.
Houston, I'm just gonna try and hit this golf ball.
Sorry about that, eh?
Every day, you get a fresh start at life.
Start fresh every day. With a smile, I'm on my way. I wanna start right with a great taste in every bite.
Start your day fresh with breakfast at Subway. Egg sandwiches made fresh with no greasy taste on fresh baked bread. Your choice of bacon, ham, Western, or cheese. Plus your favorite Subway toppings.
Start fresh every day. Subway, start fresh.
Okay, hon.
This is our winning ticket. This is our weekly check.
Nice.
Ta-da!
What?
Pool table. Well, not now, but on week 10. Week 11, the jukebox. Week 12, 13, 14, the jacuzzi. Just picture more water, less wall.
I won $1,000 times 52 weeks times 25 years.
Oh, here, that jukebox. Now.
BC Set for Life. Your chance to win $1,000 a week for 25 years.
Oh, she's got to notice me when she comes by. I mean, look at me. What's not to notice? I'm here. I tell you, if you want to feel good, you got to look good. And if I'm going to run good, I got to feel good. Look at me. I'm designed for a high-octane gas. I love it. That's what I need. This Chevron Supreme with Tech Run. I mean, it makes me run like a champ. It's all good stuff. I mean, it's mind-boggling.
No premium outperforms Chevron Supreme. Chevron with Tech Run.
I mean, I don't mean to brag or anything, but I feel stupendous.
It's the hottest contest on ice. Safeway $1 million score and win. Swipe your Safeway club card to enter. You could win $1 million or an incredible brand name prize, including a Kodak EasyShare DX6440 Zoom digital camera and camera dock. Snap a picture with the DX6440 and you'll be impressed by your photographic genius. And with its professional quality Schneider-Kreuznach Variagon lens, you'll get just the shot you want. Shop at Safeway today for your chance to win. Safeway, giving our best.
This is Hockey That Matters.
Welcome back inside General Motors Place in Vancouver for a late season battle between two of the best in the West. The Vancouver Canucks host the Colorado Avalanche in the sixth and final game of their season series. Let's meet the starting goaltenders, brought to you by Tim Hortons. Their BLT and soup combo is the home-style lunch you don't have to go home for. Another tussle between Dan Cloutier and David Abisher, each team's number one goaltenders. Cloutier is winning out so far, two wins, a loss, and a tie this season for Cloutier against the Colorado Avalanche, and David Abisher, who's won 2-2 against Vancouver. The referees that'll handle this game, Stephen Walkham and Dennis LaRue, working with Lonnie Cameron and Mike Simic on the lines. Mark Crawford's Vancouver Canucks will start Trevor Linden at center, with Jarkko Ruutu and Mike Keane on the wings against the Joe Sakic line, with Milan Hayduk and Alex Tanguay. And we wonder if Crawford will employ this line as a checking line throughout, with the defensive pair of Oland and Sopel. Here's Sakic with a quick shot and a hard one over the net. The rebound. Sopel cleared it to the corner. There's that shot of Sakic's in the first few seconds of the game, and he scored here on that shot before from just inside the blue line. Well, that one didn't miss the net by much. Here's Trevor Linden back the other way on the defensive pair of John Michael Lyles and Rob Blake. Blake's taken to the corner, double teamed by the Canucks, and Mike Keane comes in support against Sakic, trying to get control. Linden, Ryan Allen comes in off the blue line, offering some help as Linden continues to struggle along the boards here. Jarkko Ruutu in to help out. And the puck is dug out by the Avalanche. This line wants a change, but they didn't get the puck far enough. Vancouver wants a change, and they'll accommodate by shooting the puck in, and both lines will change after a minute of playing time. Onto the ice for Vancouver comes Daniel and Henrik Sedin with Matt Cook against Dan Hino. The puck carrier is Riku Hall, and Paul Kariya comes out with him. A turnover. Daniel moved in over the blue line, and John Michael Lyles takes over. He's a graduate of the USA's hockey junior program, and a good one at that. And there's an icing call against the Avalanche as Lyles put the puck down the ice because he couldn't get his change.
Well, Joe Sakic, we talked about there's having a look at his release. Look at this, right through feet. And if that hits the net, that's going to be a tough shot for Dan Cloutier to stop. An excellent shot, an excellent release. Joe Sakic, I think he is just in the zone right now. And certainly Canuck fans saw him score three goals in Colorado against Vancouver. Two of the three were on releases like that.
Such a deceptive release. He doesn't have to cock to shoot. He just snaps it.
Yeah, and it's ahead of his skates, too, instead of behind his skates. Normally, the wrist shot is generated behind your skate because you need the power to make that motion, but Sakic doesn't.
Former Canuck Darby Hendrickson on the ice here. He's got Riku Hall with him and Steve Konowalczuk. Hall, number 32, runs into Brent Sopel, and the puck comes up over top of the Colorado bench in behind it. The scratches for the Vancouver Canucks. The surprise here is Merrick Malik, who is a late scratch, and with Jovanovski already out, it means Baumgartner and Wade Brookbank are both dressed as defensemen, and we're attempting now to find out why Merrick Malik isn't in the lineup.
Yeah, it didn't seem like Malik was hurt in Columbus or ailing at the last little bit, so we'll see what happens.
Lots of ice time then for the likes of Brian Allen, who played almost 24 minutes in Columbus the other night and continues to improve and earn the ice time he's getting. He's out here with Nolan Baumgartner right now. The Sedins and Matt Cook continue up front. Andrei Nikolishin is back in the Colorado lineup wearing number 11. He's been out for 20 games with an abdominal injury. And he's with Paul Kariya and Dan Hynot. Paul Kariya and Teemu Selänne continue to play with all sorts of different line combinations in an effort to get these two great players on fire with the Avalanche. There's a long stretch pass for Kariya that he'll have to chase. And as he touches it, he's offside, so play is stopped. Tony Granato's had his fair share of injuries to deal with. He's had those great players, but he hasn't had them all in the lineup at the same time. And again, they're missing Peter Forsberg, and that's a huge absence.
Yeah, and I think that's sort of the understatement. Peter Forsberg makes so many other players better, especially as you look at Kari and Solani. And coming into the playoffs, it'll be important for Forsberg to be in fine shape.
Rob Blake holds up Marcus Naslund, who's out here with Brendan Morrison and Todd Bertuzzi, playing head-to-head with Sakic, Hayduke, and Tongan. Look at the firepower on the ice now as John Michael Lyles dumps the puck in. Olin and Sopel paired against the Sakic line, but now out with their top line. Sakic along the boards. Tongan looks for some open ice behind the net and takes the pass. Sopel took the puck away from him and swatted it down the ice. And it's got enough for icing as Carlos Trastins gets back to touch the puck. Dan Murphy.
Thank you, Jim. Don't forget to play Safeway's $1 million score and win. If any Canucks player scores 5 goals tonight, Katharina Lorenz of Chilliwack could win $1 million. Shop and swipe at Safeway, and you could be our next lucky winner.
Marcus Naslund goes to the bench. We're told, Murph, that Merrick Malik has a sore back, and that's why he's been scratched. And you know, on the eve of the trading deadline, the suspicions that start to run through the building when somebody is absent from the lineup.
So true.
There's a quick shot by Hendrickson, and a nice save by Dan Kluche. Another shot by Hendrickson. This one was blocked by Nolan Baumgartner and didn't get through. Back come the Canucks. They're 4-on-2, and May dumped the puck into the corner. Sean Pronger in after it. He's played a couple of strong games for Vancouver since being called up from Manitoba. And he's out here with Tyler Bouk and Brad May for a shift against Hendrickson, Solani, and Peter Worrell. Peter Worrell, number 28, Colorado tough guy, gets the puck out to center. Baumgartner to Brian Allen. The real test for this Vancouver defense tonight. Sopel and Salom on together now. There'll be all sorts of different combinations, and players will have to play both sides, and the Vancouver defense has been very adaptable at that. Kurt Sauer, young defenseman picked up from Anaheim by Colorado, sends the puck the distance, and we're waiting for this game between these two great teams to erupt.
Well, one of the best chances for Colorado so far comes off a Darby Hendrickson one. Face off, watch Hendrickson then pull out into that soft area and get a shot on net. This continues. Another shot by Hendrickson, and that one's blocked by Baumgartner. That was well done, not only by Dan Kluche, but his mate, Nolan Baumgartner, jumped in front of the puck.
Hendrickson in against Andrei Nikolishin in the faceoff circle. Hendricks waved out. Daniel will come in to take the draw. Nikolishin wins it cleanly. Adam Foote. Hey, he's on the ice, and Todd Bertuzzi's nowhere to be found. Carlos Skrastins trying to clear the puck. Daniel along the boards, tripped up. And the Avalanche move out. Dan Hynote. It's Connor Walchuk and Nikolishin. They start to change as they get the puck in deep. Connor Walchuk on Brent Sopel. Nikolishin gets the puck, centering pass. Hayduke couldn't come up with it. Good stick by Sallow to clear it. A good play at the blue line by John Michael Lyles to keep it in. Hayduke to Rob Blake, takes a shot. Great save by Kluche. And the puck's underneath him. Two good plays there, but the best one by John Michael Lyles to keep the play onside and set up the shot by Rob Blake.
John Michael Lyles, watch here. He's going to play a little football. Little kick, keeps the puck in traffic. And that sustains the offensive effort of creating this opportunity by Blake. So if Lyles doesn't keep the puck in, there's no offense by Colorado. You know, it's interesting. Rob Blake has not been his best of late, but you wonder if these are the types of games that he's going to break out in along with John Michael Lyles.
He's coming off a hairline fracture in his leg. He only has one assist since he's come back. But we talked about rushing defensemen in the opening, and you see his eyes light up and his feet start to move as soon as that puck was kept into the line.
Both these teams are looking to do that.
Sakic won the draw. Lyles takes the shot. Steered aside, might have been going wide by Dan Kluche. Hayduke, Tange, and Sakic back on the ice. So Brent Sopel had to change. Sallow's out with Olin against him. Sakic twists and turns in the corner. Knocked down, and the Canucks get the puck, and out starts Trevor Linden. He's got Jarkko Ruutu with him, and up comes Sammy Sallow, who takes the shot. Linden looking for the puck at the side of the net. And the fans anticipating that he might get a scoring chance. A dozen games without a point for Trevor, still stuck on 673. Here he goes with Keane, takes the shot. Abisher made the save. Bouncing puck in behind the net. Mutu went after Teemu Selänne. Now Selänne has the puck. Hooked down, perhaps trying to draw a penalty, doesn't get it. Morrell with a good lick on Olin, and Rob Blake comes up with the puck. Blake starts to move out. Sent the puck ahead, Selänne couldn't get it. Olin Baumgartner to Wade Brookbank. Gets to center, dumps the puck in. Carlos Krastins looks to dump it right back out, and he does. The defense changing quickly here. Ryan Allen and Nolan Baumgartner, who's now over on the left side, advances the puck to Morrison for Marcus Naslund. Bertuzzi's over on the right side. Morrison checked by Adam Foote. Riku Hall comes in against Marcus Naslund. Bertuzzi in that quiet zone behind the defense looking for some ice. Now he switches places with Naslund. Baumgartner for Bertuzzi behind the net. Brian Allen's gone to the front of the goal. Bertuzzi twisting and turning, trying to get away from Adam Foote. Had his stick held up and couldn't get the puck towards the net. Allen keeps the play alive from the blue line. Bertuzzi into the feet. Baumgartner gets a shot away into the feet of the defense. Now Allen takes a shot. That's blocked by the defeat of Haino. Baumgartner with a shot, and it bounced off another foot. The high note, and Connor Walchuk gets out to center. It's like football.
Without Adam Foote.
It's a game of feet.
Not inches.
Sean Pronger dumps the puck in. Brad May, Tyler Bouk with him. Kurt Sauer back to touch the puck. Takes a bump on an icing call. And they're all nose to nose here in a scoreless game on Sportsnet.
No inhibition, make no condition. Get a little out of line. The best thing about being a woman.
If you're ever uncomfortable in the all-new Colorado Crew Cab from Chevrolet, it won't be because of lack of space. After all, everything's bigger in Colorado.
Man, I feel like a woman.
Woo!
You can't leave a cup unrolled and roll up the rim to win at Tim Hortons. With 30 GMC Canyons, 100 Panasonic Plasma TVs, Schwinn Cruiser Bikes, and millions of other prizes available. So get rolling.
It's here for a limited time only. Play New Extravaganza, Canada's richest instant game, with 15 prizes of $1 million instantly. Over $40 million in total prizes. 50 hot new Volkswagen Touaregs to win instantly. And 50 instant holidays. Get your hands on Extravaganza's riches before someone else does. Play New Extravaganza. Available at your lottery retailer for a limited time only.
Here's a look at Vancouver's only shot on goal so far.
Trevor Linden with his second shot in three games. And you can see there that Darby Hendrickson just nails Mike Keane into the goaltender, Abisher.
There's Sean Pronger, Chris's older brother, set to take the faceoff here against Andrei Nikolishin. Goes out with Correa and Worrell. Scramble draw. Pronger trying to tie up Nikolishin, who got the puck to the point. Eric Morris with a shot that was deflected wide, and Brad May clears the puck to center. May, Bouk, and Pronger. Now there's going to be a scrap. Brad May, out of his weight class, taking on Pete Worrell.
You got to be careful on that first grab, and that's what they're trying to set up.
May throws one, now he's trying to grab him, get in tight, throws another right, and Worrell trying to throw a couple of rights, and Brad May's trying to get loose. There was a haymaker from Worrell, and down they go in a heap.
Well, Brad May will get A for effort here, and even though he might have tied the fight, he's going to win it in the crowd's estimation.
Just for going up against Peter Worrell.
I don't think that haymaker connected. I just think it hit him in the back of the head and just sort of knocked him down. Look at this, eye to eye. The first grab's really important. You gotta watch where you grab and where he grabs. That one there is not where I'd want to grab if I was Brad May. You'd want to be in close, and finally he is.
Peter Worrell is one big man. Matt Cook against Steve Moore.
Ah.
Moore's trying to throw right as Cook tries to hold on and get his bearings, and now Cook's starting to throw him.
Uh-oh.
His sweater's been torn off. Is he tied down?
Yep.
Steve Moore, who was public enemy number one in Vancouver after the hit on Marcus Naslund.
Let's have a look at that hit. Moore comes across. Naslund's extended, and he goes right after Naslund and knocks him out.
Naslund missed three games, and now he's over talking to the referees here to see what sort of penalties will be handed out, if there'll be extra penalties. May and Worrell, Moore and Cook.
Yeah, there might be something here about Matt Cook's tie down coming off. Let's see what they do. Cook's in the penalty box showing that it broke him in half here.
He has to show that he was tied down under the NHL's disrobing law. And you know what? I think the fans here really appreciate this. May for going with Worrell, and for Cook answering the bell.
I would agree with you. So 5-5 for both Moore and Cook.
Pretty good cheer for a Matt Cook fighting major announcement in the building. So some early fireworks that we expected last week. Maybe there were too many NHL executives there for it to happen. Hajduk with a shot, he scores! What a great shot by Milan Hajduk, doing his Joe Sakic imitation, and he snaps one home. It's 1-0 Colorado.
Well, a very quiet wrist shot gets on net and beats Dan Klutche. Milan Hajduk goes to the boards and he pulls it in. Watch the way he moves the puck. So there's the pass by Sakic. In, out, in, and he hits a corner. Post it in. The key thing that was that works for Hajduk is that he stretches out, he pulls it towards his body, and he hits a corner.
A noted Canuck killer. Another goal for Milan Hajduk against the Vancouver Canucks. And it's a 1-0 lead for the Colorado Avalanche. Losers at home yesterday. Smoked by 6 goals against the Calgary Flames. Worst home loss since they moved to Denver. You know that they'll be into this one tonight, knowing the importance of the game and trying to bounce back off a horrible loss. Hajduk from Sakic. Right after the fights. Kariya and Solani out here together with Andrei Nikolishin. Solani left the puck. Nikolishin shot. That didn't get through to the net. And out comes Tyler Bouk. He's got Mike Keane with him. Keane will have to chase the puck in along the boards. Brendan Morrison coming on as Vancouver starts to change. Brent Sopel, D to Brian Allen over the blue line. A long shot to David Abisher. That bounce off him into the corner. Marcus Naslund stepped in front of Teemu Selänne, kept the puck in deep. Derek Morris is back. Now Todd Bertuzzi's on to join his line mates. Joe Sakic, Milan Hajduk, Alex Tanguy on the ice. Naslund battles in against Carlos Skrastic. Adam Foote is there against Vancouver's top line. There's a tape-to-tape pass, Tanguy to Hajduk. Sakic coming up with him. Hajduk to Joe Sakic. Spins. Deals along the boards to Alex Tanguy. Hayduk's in behind the net after the puck. Sakic goes to the front of the goal. Sakic turns in front of the net. Foote's backhander just wide. Feeds it out in front of Brendan Morrison. Back in support. Cleared the puck away. Another active defenseman. This one Adam Foote, not noted for his scoring. Just about got one. Here's Matthias Olin the other way. His high shot. Big rebound. Morrison shoots. He just missed the net. Here's Jarkko Ruutu, put the puck towards the net. Sakic blocked it. Ruutu advances towards the net, and he runs into a wall of Skrastic and Foote. And Adam Foote takes the puck as the pace to this game starts to pick up. 9 minutes into the first period, 1-0, the Avalanche lead on the goal by Milan Hajduk. Brian Allen to Jarkko Ruutu, the drop pass to Daniel Sedin. from the blue line. Allen's shot ricocheted off a pair of Avalanche. And out come Colorado. Konowalczyk to Hall. Broken up. Back in comes Daniel Sedin. With Ruutu takes the shot. Off speed, just wide. John Michael Lyles up to Steve Konowalczyk, and he clears the puck out to center. Both teams making changes. All sorts of players at the bench, and the puck was there too. In collision, drop the puck off. John Michael Lyles in trouble against Trevor Linden with Pronger and Bump. Linden hangs on to the puck, turns to the slot on his backhand. Can't get the shot to the net. Linden again turns, passes off. Matthias Olin looks to the other side, passes back to Trevor Linden. Screenshot, stopped by Ebisher. And the rebound goes to Teemu Selänne, and he dumps the puck out of harm's way, getting it down the ice. And Trevor Linden is skating well early in the game and gets a huge round of applause here as he comes close to tying this game. Olson Canucks Hockey returns after this.
When the Coors Light Brewing Company puts its mind to something, we follow through. You said you wanted a beer that would be ice cold. Done. You said you wanted a beer with an easy drinking taste. So be it. You said you wanted to meet those girls over there.
You can do that?
Hey, we make beer, not miracles. Coors Light, the silver bullet.
It's the hottest contest on ice. Safeway $1 million score and win. Swipe your Safeway club card for your chance to win a Hoover Floormate hard floor cleaner, a cellular foam plus Fido airtime package from Wireless Wave, a Karcher K399M pressure washer, or a Kodak EasyShare DX6440 zoom digital camera and dock. Get a bonus entry when you buy Viva paper towels. Viva, the hard working towel. Shop at Safeway today for your chance to win.
Let's have a look at Adam Foote sneaking in and watch Marcus Nazem, who's a plus 18 right here. If Nazem doesn't stay on Adam Foote, that's a goal. Nazem, one of the reasons that he's plus 18 is he's very detailed now in the defensive side of the puck for Marcus Nazem.
Out here with Morrison and Bertuzzi, his team trailing 1-0, the goal by Milan Hejduk, 33rd of the season for the Rocket Richard Trophy owner of last season, and his 21st goal in 32 games against the Vancouver Canucks. Nikolajan's waved out. Darby Henriksen, also a centerman, comes in against the other number 7. Nice draw, won by Morrison with his foot. Baumgartner from the other side. And there's a penalty to Todd Bertuzzi for interference in the faceoff.
Yeah, it's faceoff interference. I'm not sure. I want to have a look at this. I'm not sure I agree. It's Todd Bertuzzi going for the puck here. He moves the puck back with his foot, and then he plays a little bit of sort of normal interference. This normally happens. Let's have a look. So the one faceoff comes off of the Bertuzzi foot.
Didn't see him interfere anywhere on that one. He just jumped in and got the puck when Morrison kicked it back. Interference at 10:08, so the first power play of the game goes to the Colorado Avalanche, already leading 1-0. Sackett, Tanguay, Hejduk stay together up front. Blake and John Michael Lyles has taken over as the number one power play point man from Derek Morris, or anybody else for that matter. Paul Kariya can play back there, but it's John Michael Lyles because he's a very good passer, good offensive defenseman, slight of build, a bit like Brian Rafalski of the New Jersey Devils. He's really earned the ice time on the top power play unit for Colorado. Rob Blake sets up from the blue line. Matthias Olin, Brent Sopel, Mike Keane, Tyler Bout, out killing the penalty, at least to get it started. Sopel couldn't get the puck out against Tanguay. Hejduk to Joe Sackett. Milan Hejduk, in comes Rob Blake to the slot, tips through to Tanguay, can't get the shot away, feeds it back into the middle. Tipped by Mike Keane, and Tyler Bout got the puck out to center, and now he pursues it. Lyle steers him outside. Bout takes a bump from Blake. And he continues to hold the puck in here along the boards and work the clock. Great penalty killing for Tyler Bouk, who took one for the team there. And now we'll want to change. Here comes Teemu Selänne with Steve Konowalczyk and Paul Kariya. Salani's knocked down by Brian Allen. Sammy Salo gets the puck and he clears it. Colorado's power play fourth in the league against the second best penalty killing unit. Very good special teams for both of these teams, although Colorado's power play has been better than Vancouver's. Paul Kariya ran into Selänne. That says a lot about the season these two have had.
And Teemu Selänne has been going at it with Brian Allen. Allen took him down. Selänne went back at Allen all the way up ice. So they've got a little something happening there.
Just 10 seconds to go in the Bertuzzi penalty. Round of the boards, Derek Morris with Adam Foote on the other side. All he can do is shovel the puck in to Steve Konowalczyk. Salo breaks the play up and clears it. And the penalty killers look good as Bertuzzi returns to the ice and the teams are 5-on-5 once again. 1-0, Colorado leads on Milan Hayduk's goal. Skrastic kicked the puck. Hall took a hit from Todd Bertuzzi as Hall cleared the puck the length of the ice. Matias Olund is back, icing against Colorado.
The first period is brought to you by General Motors and all its division. Visit us at gmcanada.com.
Good penalty killing here for Tyler Bouk, who takes a hit but just eats the puck along the boards.
Yeah, it is a nice job of just hanging onto the puck here with his skate. Finally, it's John Michael Lyles, it sort of pulls him down. You get the feeling, though, Jim, of late that this game is going to be very aggressive.
Well, the pace has really picked up here in the last few minutes. The hitting is big. There's been a couple of fights. Here's Matt Cook. Back into the action with the Sedins, Daniel and Henrik. Centering pass and a loose puck up for grabs high in the slot. Taken by Riku Hall. He's with Dan Heinout and Andrei Nikulishin. Baumgartner back for the puck. Heino lines him up. Got more boards than he did Baumgartner, who saw the hit coming, and the puck is cleared out to center. Morris couldn't gather it in. Here comes Matt Cook. Dumped the puck in. Daniel Sedin goes in after Derek Morris. Takes the man. The puck goes to Kurt Sauer. Up the boards to Heino. Quick pass through to Hall and a good breakout for Colorado. They get to center at the end of a shift and dump the puck in. What a waste of a good breakout.
What we do in alumni hockey. It's called dump and change.
Here's Brendan Morrison to Sopel and to Todd Bertuzzi. Get over the blue line backwards with the puck called offside.
Whether we work on your car or you do it yourself, we have quality auto parts at the right price at Canadian Tire.
Chevrolet Hockey Poll for Chevrolet for all life's roads. Now log on to sportsnet.ca and answer this question. Which Canuck would you most like to see interviewed in a future Sportsnet telecast? Nazem Bertuzzi, Kuche, or firmly in cheek on the eve of the training deadline, Miroslav Chatan.
Interesting.
I sense in the community that people want to trade, any trade. Just doesn't matter.
Could be for
they want in on the action.
I'm wondering if a Washington trainer might go soon.
Joe Sakic looking for someone to pass to. Depends on how much money those Washington trainers make. Brent Sopel up the boards. John Michael Lyles keeps the puck in. Olund in front of the net. Cleared the puck away. Out comes Routou to Trevor Linden. He's got Sopel up with him. And Sopel was just ahead of him and the play was offside. Murph.
Thanks, Jim. March 24th, the big night. It's the 2004 Canucks for Kids Fund Telethon. Help the team support Canuck Place and Children's Hospice during the Canucks Kings game. Donate $100 and receive an exclusive top-line photo.
We'll be on the air for that game. Rogers Sportsnet Pacific.
Vancouver Canucks are 17 games above 500. But as I see it, only four games above 500 at home.
Very similar teams, Colorado and Vancouver, this season. Colorado has the third best record in the league on the road, 16th at home. Vancouver's fourth best on the road, 15th at home.
Yeah.
Neither of them have played their best games on home ice. Their goals for and against are almost dead even. Special teams are close to each other, and they're 1 point apart in the standings in the Northwest Division. Go figure.
Amazing. Colorado 16 games above 500. Vancouver at this point 17 games above 500. I always like that stat. Just sort of gives a quick indicator of how your season's gone.
The old adage is you wanted to play at least 500 on the road and make hay at home. And I'm not sure that that's the case anymore because there isn't as much home ice advantage around the league. But it's still, especially for Western teams, more difficult to play all those road games because there are some grueling trips that are hard to get points on.
You remember, though, if you think of the way that expectations have changed here in Vancouver, it wasn't many years ago if a Vancouver Canucks team, played 500, Jim. Pretty good season. Big difference now. 17 games above 500, you have a bad game, it's not good.
Now the season doesn't start till the 6th of April. Play slows a little bit here again. These teams are careful with each other. 5.5 minutes to go in the first period. Marcus Naslin stripped to the puck by Darby Henriksen, who darts over after it, coming off the bench. Steve Konowalczuk dumped the puck in. Brian Allen slammed to the boards by Konowalczuk as he tried to clear the puck. Hinote bats at it. Riku Hall knocked the puck down to Hinote. Great save. Rebound. They score. Konowalczuk on the rebound. And he got it started with a great hit on Brian Allen and gets the goal to make it 2-0 Colorado.
Well, this is a rebound that shouldn't have happened. Todd Bertuzzi had Konowalczuk, Steve Konowalczuk, and then lets him go. A little touch here. Watch the puck go to the front of the net. And Bertuzzi pinches down, comes down as a winger there, but doesn't have Konowalczuk in time. Here's a better look. Puck comes out. See on the backside, Konowalczuk has position on Bertuzzi, and that's why the rebound goes from his backhand in behind Klucic.
We'll talk a lot about deadline deals, but one of the best deals to enhance a team's playoff possibilities came early in this season when Steve Konowalczuk moved from Washington to Colorado. I think he's going to be a handy playoff player. His ruggedness set that play up. He hit Brian Allen and forced him to throw that puck up the boards. Tange centering. Colorado 2, Vancouver nothing. Konowalczuk from Hinote and Riku Hall at 14:40, and the Avalanche are back on the attack. Sakic shot knocked down, loose puck, he scores! Joe Sakic, 3-0 Colorado.
Well, this is a problem between, this isn't so much a Joe Sakic great play, although it was. This was a communication issue between Sopel and his goaltender, Klucic. Number 3, right there. See that?
You take it, I got it.
Yeah, they didn't communicate. Sopel didn't know if he was going to get it. Klucic was trying to help him get it. And the problem was that in that lack of communication came in Joe Sakic, who put a top corner.
You could see that in and freeze it. That was probably the best play. Sopel just wanted to get it out of there. Neither happened. Deposited in the net by Joe Sakic. 29 seconds. Here's Henriksen in for another. He scores! Darby Henriksen tripped up, scored as he went down, and it's 4-0 Colorado.
And Mark Crawford just gave a nod to Hedberg. He's going to come in now. Now that's a tough one for Dan Klucic, and he shouldn't take all the blame on this. Watch here. Out of nowhere, you're going to see Darby Henriksen, and he just gets position on a defenseman in a forward. And that's Tyler Bouk that he beats to the front of the net. And as he's falling, he puts it on the ice, posting in.
Konowalczuk, then 29 seconds later. Sakic, then 22 seconds later. Darby Henriksen in 51 seconds. This game has gone from 1-0 to 4-0. Henriksen from Derek Moore. Sakic with another shot, and he just missed the net. Welcome to the game, Johan Hedberg. The Avalanche are on fire, ahead 4-0, and the Canucks are stationary and having trouble in their own zone. Nolan Baumgartner for Brian Allen. Kariya over to check him, and Allen gets the puck the length of the ice. Lyles is back, icing against Vancouver. Heydu, Konowalczuk, Sakic, and Henriksen, 4-0 Colorado on Molson Canucks hockey.
Introducing the new Chevrolet Optra. It's stylish, even when you're not. We'll be right back.
We're leaving, Mr. Larson. Thank you for hosting our career day field trip.
Oh, it was great having you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, I've got something for each of you to take along.
Ooh.
Here you go. There's a lot of good stuff in there.
Oh.
Put your hands out. Where's my big man?
Okay. Mr. Larson, they're fourth graders, not file cabinets.
Staples Business Depot has easier ways to get organized. Staples Business Depot. That was easy.
Let's get them, boys.
Molson Canadian Canucks Hockey. Canucks. Oilers. Coverage begins Friday at 5:30.
Johan Hedberg is in the game. Dan Cloutier is gone. 4 goals on 10 shots. The Avalanche with a huge lead, and Hedberg was coming off a shutout. Back-to-back Saturday night shutouts.
Well, Johan Hedberg was very good in Columbus in the first period. He held his team in. We'll see if he still continues with the magic here.
He really needs to close the door here. There's still lots of time left for a very good offense, but it's 5-0. Steve Moore. And the onslaught continues as the Avalanche take a 5-0 lead, and Steve Moore tucked that one in.
Well, that was Wade Brookbank that spent some time on Peter Worrell, who out-battled Brookbank for the puck. Watch this. Okay, so Brookbank's going after his back, but Worrell hangs onto the puck, gets it to Moore off the post, and he deposits it right underneath Johan Hedberg. So the Canucks' defensive zone coverage is falling apart at this point.
They've been playing a lot in recent games with 5D and one extra. Nolan Baumgartner eating up some valuable minutes. Wade Brookbank played almost 10 the other night in Columbus, but he looks early in this game and they're feeling the effects of the absence of Merrick Malik, a late scratch with a bad back. Daniel Sedin tips the puck through, 5-0. Who'd have figured this? Steve Moore from Peter Worrell, the latest goal.
I know, especially after the Avs losing 7-1 against Calgary here recently.
And another shot, this time by Paul Kariya. Hedberg makes the save. It's 13-4, the shots for Colorado.
Whether we work on your car or you do it yourself, we have quality auto parts at the right price at Canadian Tire.
Sportsnet News tonight with Don Taylor at 10 o'clock. We'll have a complete report on this game with post-game interviews with Dan Murphy, plus a look at all the other games in the NHL tonight, including a great tilt between Tampa Bay and the Red Wings. Carlos Skrastins for the Avalanche puts another puck towards the net, and it's just wide. Adam Foote trying to hold the puck in. Sakic along the boards. Salo to Mike Keane. Jarkko Ruutu took a shot that was blocked by Rob Blake. Bouncing puck, and Blake tries to clear the puck. Ruutu won't let it out. Trevor Linden on with Mike Keane. Jarkko Ruutu. Linden leaves the puck for Salo. Back to Linden. Lobs one of the net. Lyles knocked it down. And out comes Alex Tanguay with Joe Sakic and Milan Hayduk. Passes behind Hayduk, forcing him to turn. Rob Blake can't dump the puck in. Matias Olin looking ahead for Todd Bertuzzi. The puck is out of his reach. Here's Rob Blake scrapping now with Jarkko Ruutu. Third fight of the game. Blake's throwing hard lefts, and Ruutu gets inside on him and grabs on.
Jarkko Ruutu always surprises me at how strong he is. Rob Blake's a big boy.
Jarkko Ruutu always surprises when he handles the big guys like that. It is so game. Not known as a scrapper, but he handled himself pretty well there.
He's really learned this part of the game. He tends to get inside and then land whatever he can.
A push, a hold, a shove, let's go.
Oh, that's pretty good. First punch by Blake, last punch by Jarkko Ruutu. It's a couple.
Oh, he hit the glass.
Oh, that hurt.
I think he had that elbow pad over his hand like a boxing glove.
Oh, that was a pretty good right hand that Jarkko Ruutu finished off with.
Glad I'm 150 feet away from that. Ryan Allen slammed at the boards again by Steve Konowalczyk off the faceoff. They met before. Konowalczyk hit Allen hard earlier just before he scored his goal.
Brad May, Adam Foote come together. Actually, that was Todd Bertuzzi, my fault. Of course, they always get together.
The Avalanche smarting from that loss at home yesterday have come in here meaning business. They hit hard right from the outset. They've outshot Vancouver 13-4 and have a 5-0 lead.
Brad May just went right after a high note. And Adam Foote steps in.
Says, pick me.
They don't know who to line up here.
May wants Heino. Pushes him. Heino's not going to go. Allen, Deshaun Pronger.
Guess who jumps on the
ice?
Yeah,
the police have arrived.
There we go.
Here we go. Brad May and Peter Worrell again. Round number two. Uh-oh.
Peter Worrell jumped on the ice real quick.
Worrell rolled up his sleeves. Brad May gets in, throwing him to start. Round two, May, Worrell, complete. There's been some nastiness in this tilt.
Right off the bat, Brad May came onto the ice. And gave it to Heino here. Just chatted with him. Called him a few things that probably Heino didn't like. Heino didn't respond, but Peter Worrell did. Worrell jumped off. There was a quick change, and Worrell jumped onto the ice, and that's how this started.
Tony Granato, the coach of the Avalanche, under much scrutiny of late, but up 5-0 right now. I think Mark Crawford will like the combative nature of some of the scraps, that sort of thing, of May and Cook, but he wants the game to be a heck of a lot closer. Here's Teemu Selänne with a shot, and Johan Hedberg makes the save and hangs on. He's given up one of the 5 goals. May and Worrell go off for fighting. Teemu Selänne hasn't had a point in 11 games. It's a mystery why he hasn't been able to be a better player for the Colorado Avalanche. They brought in Selänne and Kariya to join Sakic, Haydu, Tange, Forsberg. Those players have only been in the lineup 16 games together. It just hasn't worked out as well as they might have hoped.
One of the things that is very noticeable about Paul Kariya is his shots. They've been better of late. He's had 13 in his last 5 games. In comparison to Marcus Naslund, who's had 18 shots in his last 5 games. But Jim, the 5 shots that Kariya had against the Canucks here recently, that was only the second time that he has had 5 shots in a game.
Here he is passing to the blue line to Kurt Sauer, whose shot goes wide of the net. The blue line, Morris with a shot, the rebound, loose in front of the net. Hendrickson couldn't get it. Steve Moore is there as well. John Pronger comes up with the puck. Morris got a high stick in the face. There's going to be a penalty here to Tyler Bauk. Both referees with their arms in the air. Now we'll check Morris to determine the severity of the penalty. It comes with a minute 15 seconds left in a first period that can't end fast enough.
Tyler Bauk goes out to the blue line. There's the high stick, trying to get the puck out. Aaron Stick, there's your penalty.
Avalanche on the power play for the second time. 0-for-1 so far. And Morrison snapped the puck straight down the ice. Morrison, Cook, Oland, and Salo start the penalty kill. Sakic, Tange, Hajduk up front. Lyles and Foote. In the absence of Rob Blake, he's off for fighting. Morrison spins, now he'll rag the puck, kill some time in this penalty, and he plays it back into Matthias Olin. We're in the last minute of the first period. The Avalanche with 4 goals in less than 2 minutes. 14-40. They started the onslaught by 16-19 of the period. The game was 5-0.
We're going to have a penalty here. Ryan Allen got knocked down in the corner. The puck went out. I thought maybe Nicolishan was going to go. The arm sort of went up as Nicolishan took down Ryan Allen. It was the puck out of the net.
It's going to be a penalty to Johan Hedberg. That's what it's going to be, for clearing the puck over the glass. It went clearly out. I thought maybe it was deflected. It wasn't.
Feels a lot like this period, doesn't it, for the Vancouver Canucks? It's an indication of how things have gone. Johan Hedberg put a puck over the boards.
So it's a 5-on-3 for the last 27 seconds of this period. And perhaps to start the second. Morris and Kariya, the point man, with his 5-on-3 with Sakic, Hajduk, and Tanguay up front. Kariya to Milan Hajduk, a dozen seconds to go into period. Trevor Linden slashed at the puck, couldn't get it. Kariya battles for it. In comes Sakic, and in comes Hajduk to Joe Sakic. Running out of time, Kariya will have to get the shot away. And they don't get it off in time. The buzzer sounds. The first period has come to an end. The first period owned by the Avalanche. The shot's 15-4. And they did most of the scoring in a 2-minute span. Our panel is along in the first intermission with a deadline tomorrow. Home Hardware's Coast to Home is around as well in the first intermission with a 5-0 score.
The first period is brought to you by General Motors and all its divisions. Visit us at gmcanada.com. Close to Home, brought to you by Home Hardware, where help is close to home. What hits close to home for Brent Sopel of Saskatoon, Saskatchewan?
How many times have you been in the middle of a job and needed a different tool? And then you have to find it. Not a problem with the amazing Benchmark Flip Grip, available only at your local Home Hardware or Home Building Center. When you need to switch, all you have to do is flip. From needle nose to flat nose and back.
Now there's a new Flip Grip Mini. Small, convenient, and flips from needle nose with wire strippers to cutters. You'll flip over it too. Pick up a Benchmark Flip Grip and a Flip Grip Mini today. Only at Home Hardware. Help is close to home.
At Home, we believe in making a difference in our communities. Purchase this elegant wood-handled automatic umbrella for $14.97 at Home Hardware, and you'll be supporting three national charities. At Home Hardware, help is close to home.
When you're in Saskatoon and during the wintertime, there's not a lot to do. So ice was everywhere, backyards, rinks, outdoor rinks. The coaches I had were huge influences on me, pushing me to be out there practicing every day, any opportunity I had to, after schools, and just along my side, pushing me along the way. One memory I had was going to Major Junior with Saskatoon Blades and playing the first game there in front of, my hometown, my friends and my family there. So that's definitely my big memory.
Another installment of Close to Home from Home Hardware, where help is close to home.
Been saving my scratch to buy my dream whip. I'm not about the luxury, not even a bit. Square's not my deal, gotta have the right feel. I need to roll in something a little more real. Now this classic ride fills me with pride, and I'm itching to cruise in my fresh new brews. Yeah, I bought these wheels cause I've been eating McDeal.
The Everyday McDeal menu. Get a different deal every day of the week for only $1.69 plus tax.
McDonald's, ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it.
So, Dan, do we have everything we need for this meeting?
It's all right here, sir.
Is your data backup as reliable as it should be?
Don't worry, sir. You told me everything.
Ours is Storage Software Solutions from Computer Associates.
The First Intermission, brought to you by Future Shop. Come see what your future has in store.
The Ottawa Senators and Philadelphia Flyers set the tone on Friday in terms of attempting to settle a score. And obviously tonight, the Colorado Avalanche and the Vancouver Canucks are following suit. I'm joined in Hockey Central by Nick Kiprios, Gord Stellick, and John Garrett, making a rare appearance here on the panel during a Vancouver Canucks game. So because he's here, we'll allow him to take us through the first period.
I should be there. 5-0 Colorado, John.
5-0. Explain how this could be.
Well, last week, retribution because the game was close. Well, yeah. Tonight it hasn't been close. And goaltending, you have to make some big saves. And Dan Kluche, the wrist shot by Hayduk, his feet are going. He loses the net. This one, okay, no chance on this one. It's a rebound. He makes a good save. But here, look at this one. Rebound. Joe Sakic, bad rebound. And Darby Hendrickson scoring on you on a breakaway. And then Johan Hedberg, he follows suit with, when you come in off the bench, make some big saves early. That's
so
all you have to do.
An off game for Dan Kluche, or is this a bigger concern heading into the playoffs?
I hope it's an off game for Dan Kluche. I look at it and the problem is that the Vancouver Canucks realize this game is for the Northwest Division title.
Sure it is.
This game is a playoff game. And your goalie has a first period like that.
Very physical period of hockey, Nick. Full credit, I think, to Brad May for battling Peter Worrell, not once, but twice.
Well, there's a reason why Brad May's still in the league. Number one, he's a great team guy. Number two, he knows when a job needs to get done, he's going to go out there and do it. He's not going to look over his shoulder and wait for someone else to do it. He's battled a guy that he gives up, 6 inches and maybe 30, 40 pounds? And yet he did a pretty good job against a guy that's considered one of the toughest guys in the league. And don't be so sure that this thing isn't
long
over
night.
A long shot. There's 40 minutes to go, and there's still a lot of bad blood out there.
Well, a couple things. And John Garrett should be there. He should be in goal tonight in Vancouver's number one. But the other thing, talk about a guy sticking up, and more on Colorado as well. I mean, here's a situation where this is a guy that go right after him. He acquits himself pretty well in this fight, in this dust-up. And for the Colorado Avalanche, like John said, this is a game for first place tonight. Keep in mind, they went through the low point of the season yesterday. When you have a horrible game, you love to get back at it sooner rather than later. They get to go at it the next night. This is a perfect script for Tony Granato and company, and it all started with that quiet goal.
Business of the day, and that involves trades across the National Hockey League on the eve of NHL trade deadline day. The most recent involving the Calgary Flames as Daryl Sutter continues to add, and in the process, I suppose, subtract, but this time he gives up a second round pick this summer to the Florida Panthers for Marcus Nielsen, who's got a bit of a mean streak. He'll add some size there too. Earlier, Los Angeles picking up forward Anson Carter for a prospect player and forward Jared Allen, who goes to the Washington Capitals. The Philadelphia Flyers and the New York Rangers making a swap. Vladimir Malakhov to the Flyers for Rick Kozak and a second round pick next summer. And the Dallas Stars were searching for a defenseman. They find him in Philadelphia and Chris Therrien in exchange for an 8th-round pick in June and a 3rd-round pick in 2005. But, John, let's begin with the Calgary Flames and the acquisition of Marcus Nielsen.
Well, they needed some experience depth at forward, and I think Daryl Sutter did a good job. Here's Marcus Nielsen, a former first-round pick, 6 years' experience in the league, and he gives Daryl some more options up front. He got Chris Simon on the weekend. Simon gives him size and some power forward for the power play, and now Nielsen gives him more depth.
This shouldn't be of concern to other teams in the Western Conference, in particular Canadian teams. I guess the Vancouver Canucks are the only one legitimately now in the playoffs, Gord. But is this the kind of tinkering that Brian Burke should be concerned with? And perhaps he should get involved in the next several hours.
Well, I think the two teams tonight, Vancouver and Colorado, are the only two of the real contenders that haven't done any tinkering. So I would answer the question, yes. Should he be concerned about that trade? No, that's not stop the presses, end of the world. But there's two points to it. Number one, you do better your team when you make those moves. And number two, and it's very important, we've talked about it, you do send a message to your fans, and inside the dressing room, the management's trying to make that little tweak that can help make the difference come playoffs.
Well, Brian marches to his own drum, and he will not feel the pressure of public perception just to go out to make a deal to make a deal. Yeah. That's not Brian's style. It'll only be if it makes sense. And still, the name that I keep hearing is Rutschinski out of New York.
And maybe the price comes down on Martin Rutschinski out of New York just because Anson Carter now goes to the Los Angeles Kings. And There was so much speculation, Nick, that the Los Angeles Kings could have been the front runner for a player like Rutschinski.
Yeah, but you're right. They'd go get a guy like Anson Carter and a guy that who has the ability to put the puck in the net. They're looking over their shoulders. They're looking at St. Louis knocking on the door. St. Louis has got a much easier schedule in terms of sub-500 teams. Los Angeles is going to face the likes of top Western teams, so it's going to be tough, but Anson Carter helps.
Well, Brian Burke is probably more concerned with the immediate future of the Vancouver Canucks, and that's period number two against the Colorado Avalanche. 5-0 after one period of play. Burke perhaps making a splash on deadline day. If he does, we'll assess, and perhaps during a lapse, analyze Dan Murphy's new hairdo. Wow! He'll join us after this.
Where's Dave Gagne in?
Canadian Club Best Shots, brought to you by Canadian Club. 151 countries, one ride.
Robert Lang just about had his first as a Detroit Red Wing, getting the rebound off the backboards, and Dan Couture kept it out. Vancouver's made it a two-goal game, and a shot right off the faceoff. Detroit has defeated Vancouver 3-1.
Closed captioning brought to you by Montana's. Join us for a little R&R every Wednesday. All you can eat ribs and an ice cold Rickards.
For the first time ever, the United States has become the first nation to walk on the moon.
Houston, I'm just gonna try and hit this golf ball. Huh?
Ottawa, we have a problem here.
I am Canadian!
Sorry about that, eh?
And it's Smith now sweeping it across to McCoy. McCoy in the box and...
Unique situation here. Four offensive players flooding in toward...
Four attacking players flooding in toward the box. Smith tossed to McCoy.
Understand the situation here. Führer Anfalls per Aristotel Mollet. Smith passed out to McCoy. Oh!
No! Oh, we really did give it some welly.
151 countries, one ride, Canadian Club.
So that's the service bay. Okay. This is the customer waiting area. And that is the posting board.
Okay.
Your first job is to go through these.
Boy, they work us like dogs around here, don't they?
And cut out the competition's ads.
That's good thinking, because you don't want people reading.
And you post them up there.
That's really dumb.
Well, that way our customers don't have to go all over town to compare prices. They can see that we offer great deals right here.
It's going to be awfully tough to compete with an offer like this.
Well, that's one of ours.
That's why you're in management. And, you know, I'm not.
For all your car needs, Fountain Tire, home of the tire experts, and a whole lot more.
Every day, you get a fresh start at life.
Start fresh every day. With a smile, I'm on my way. I want to start right with a great taste in every bite.
Start your day fresh with breakfast at Subway. Egg sandwiches made fresh with no greasy taste on fresh baked bread. Your choice of bacon, ham, Western, or cheese. Plus your favorite Subway toppings.
Start fresh every day. Subway, start fresh.
The trade deadline is about 16 hours away, and if you want all the up-to-date info, tune into Sportsnet News and Hockey Central at the deadline. Get started tomorrow at 9 o'clock Pacific. Steve Konowalczyk joins me now, who came over from Washington before the real fire sale began. And Steve, after the loss yesterday, what did you guys say as veterans before this game?
Well, I think we're all sick to our stomach, you know, and that was the most important thing. It was a terrible game, and we put it behind us, and, you know, we wanted to come out with a lot of energy, and... you know, obviously we fed off Big Pete and Steve Moore there, a great job, and just gave us a lot of emotion.
Let's take a look at your goal now, which made it 2-0.
Well, it was just my line mate's digging. You know, I think we just want to get pucks to the net, and Danny came, great pass by Rico there, and I was there for the rebound, but nothing fancy, and you're not going to get anything fancy from us.
Quickly now, we've seen some rough stuff already. How does a team that's 5-up try to avoid it with still 2 periods to go?
Well, we're just gonna play. You know, if they wanna make it dirty, you know, we're just gonna have to play. We'll play hard. We're gonna try to stay disciplined. Obviously, we want to stay out of the box, not get many extra life here. But you know, we're just gonna try to keep playing the same way.
Good luck down the stretch.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Steve Konowalczyk of the Colorado Avalanche, his team with a big first period lead. 5 goals he scored in the first as they lead the Canucks 5-0 after 20 minutes. Back with more in just a moment.
The first intermission brought to you by Future Shop. Come see what your future has in store.
son was a deeply, deeply disturbed person. Not was, is.
Taking lives. That's what Martin Asher's been doing for almost 20 years. His first victim he covered up with a car accident, and then he took the boy's identity.
I saw him, and I can show you what he looks like.
All of these men have something in common. Simply a life different from his own.
In a series of murders...
That man's face was half gone!
The most deadly suspect...
He knows that I'm cooperating with the police? The bait always dies.
It is our best shot at catching this guy.
Is a killer who becomes his victims. Angelina Jolie, Ethan Hawke, Kiefer Sutherland.
Help me!
Taking lives.
Something terrible is going to happen.
One reason we decided to start renting tuxedos at Moore's is because guys aren't just wearing them for weddings anymore. It could be a date, a fancy dinner, or the prom. They head to Moore's, select the style they want, get fitted, pick it up, and off they go. So when you rent a tuxedo from Moore's, you can relax and feel confident you'll look good on special occasions. Even the most important ones. Tuxedo rental packages from as little as $60. Well made, well priced, well dressed. Moore's.
Welcome back to General Motors Place in Vancouver. It's 5-0 Colorado. Yes, that's 5-0 Colorado to start the second period. A look at the summary brought to you by Moore's Clothing for Men. Well made, well priced, well dressed. 4 goals in a minute 39 seconds for the Colorado Avalanche. And you see they spread it around. 4 different abs. Steve Moore finishing it off at 16-19, a decided advantage in shots on goal. The big line for Vancouver, -7, and Marcus Naslund only played 4.5 minutes. And the Avalanche just added another player, too. We're told by our Hockey Central trade trackers that Matthew Barnaby has just become a Colorado Avalanche. Picked up for a prospect from the New York Rangers, so they add a little more toughness to go with Peter Worrell and Jim Cummins. And Barnaby can do a few other things as well. He'd love to be in the thick of the first period of this game. Two-man advantage here for the Avalanche to start the second period. Vancouver facing a 5-on-3, down 5-0. Paul Kariya, who hasn't got in on all the scoring yet, out with Tanguay and Hajduk. Sakic back at the left point with Derek Morris on the right. Morris moves into the middle, fakes the shot. Kariya takes the shot. Johan Hedberg makes the save. Alex Tanguay to the blue line to Derek Morris. Joe Sakic. Passes off to Hajduk, gets a return pass, moves into the middle and gives the puck back to Hajduk. Back to Sakic, to Milan Hajduk, shoots, Hedberg makes a blocker save. Kariya moves the puck over, one penalty's expired, Bucks coming back on. Milan Hajduk leaves the puck to Derek Morris, it's a 5-on-4 now for another 40 seconds. Hajduk, Tanguay for Kariya, intercepted by Salo and cleared down the ice.
Well, Jim, in the first period, 9 different Avalanche players had points. 13 different players had shots on net, so they very much dominated in the first, and we'll see if the Canucks can sort of get their stuff together here and get back at it in the second.
Sakic just offside with 19 seconds to go in the penalty. Well, records were set in the first period, the fastest 3 goals ever for the Avalanche in 51 seconds, and the fastest 4 ever against Vancouver. Connor Walchuk, Sakic, Henriksen, and Moore, and the other 4 had come Winnipeg Jets some years back.
Wow.
Troubling to see such a one-sided game in a game that means so much at this time of the season.
Well, and you could feel the buzz in GM Place. People were very much looking forward to this game.
Brent Sopel steps out of the penalty box. Serving the penalty for Johan Hedberg after he delayed the game by unintentionally clearing the puck over the glass. And the teams are 5-on-5 once again.
And if you were in that Canuck dressing room in between periods, obviously Canucks very disappointed. They would have talked about getting one and then getting two and then getting three. It's a piece at a time and a shift at a time. It's about all you can try to reconstruct after a period like they just had in the first.
The Avalanche had their worst game of the season yesterday, coming out with maybe their best game of the season today, and it's a reversal for the Vancouver Canucks. Big lines on the ice with Morrison, Naslund, and Bertuzzi. Colorado's changing on the fly. Here comes Salo to Morrison. Bertuzzi in on the right wing. Watched by Carlos Skrastin. Stops up. Sopel at the blue line. Keeps the play alive. Rushing onto the puck. Grant Sopel around the net. Feeds to the open point. Nolan Baumgartner has to rush over to get the puck. All he can do is dump it into the corner. Morrison takes foot, but he couldn't get the puck. Joe Sakic starts out. Tanguay and Hajduk crisscross. Sakic left the puck. Hajduk had to go back for it. Along the boards, Brent Sopel comes up with the puck and moves it ahead to Marcus Naslund. He's got Henrik Sedin in front of him. Just onside as they cross the blue line. Naslund at the end of a shift dumps the puck to the end boards. Kurt Sauer is back. He's confronted, stopped, and turned back by Daniel Sedin. Foot to Sauer. And off the boards to center. Hajduk at the end of a shift. Sakic wants to get the puck in deep. A hand pass stops play. Dan Murphy.
Tonight's game is brought to you by this week's featured Safeway participating product, Viva Paper Towels. Viva, the hardworking towel.
David Lifeton is the player out of the Colorado organization. He plays with the Plymouth Whalers. Then the Avalanche came up to get Matthew Barnaby in a deal just completed. And there may be some more action, and people anticipate that the Vancouver Canucks will be in some action too. And you wonder if inactivity, the distraction of off-ice situations like Brian Burke's, any of that stuff has an effect on what's going on the ice.
Sounds like Lithiston, I'll get that right, was a second-round pick in 2003. So the New York Rangers trying to rebuild a little bit. It feels a bit weird to be saying that for New York, doesn't it? The fire sale continues.
In Washington as well, I think Tampa Bay still has three games to play against Washington down the stretch, which might enhance their chances of finishing first overall now. Hedberg out of his net. Up the glass to Wade Brookbank, who tipped the puck to center. Sauer is there. And he dumps the puck in for Teemu Selänne. His shot off the inboards, and Johan Hedberg covers up at the side of the net.
The second period is brought to you by The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
You know, I thought in the first period that maybe it was the absence of Marek Milik that really contributed to the downfall. Nolan Baumgartner was a minus two. Wade Brookbank was on for one of those goals, but Matthias Olin and Brent Sopel reached minus two. Salo and Allen were on for one of the goals. Everybody was a part of it. Peter Worrell to the front of the net. Sammy Salo steps in front of Teemu Selänne. And he moves the puck ahead to Brendan Morrison. Marcus Naslund for Todd Bertuzzi. Bertuzzi trying to fight to the net right in front. Allen couldn't get a shot away as he jumped into the front of the goal. And the puck has cleared the length of the ice. There's a great chance for Brian Allen. And the Canucks continue to bring their defense. And Allen's done a lot of that without results lately. But sooner or later, he's going to start to score.
Absolutely. And this is a positive, certainly, for the Vancouver Canucks, is to see Brian Allen and just his feel, his touch to get to the front of the net. So Bertuzzi holds up. He just sort of manhandles, scratches there. And then watch here. Brian Allen comes into your play, into your screen there. And you're right. He came very close to making that a good scoring chance.
Darby Henriksen, out with Steve Konowalczuk and Dan Hynote. Sean Pronger with Mike Keane and Tyler Bouk. And they dump the puck in deep. David Abisher will play it. Then he decides not to drop it with some traffic in front and holds on for a faceoff 5 minutes into this second period.
Well, when you were highlighting our two goaltenders, we looked at Abisher and Kluche. And tonight, David Abisher has not allowed any goals through a period in a bit. Last night, Philip Sauvé obviously allowed seven. So a real up and down time here for the Colorado Avalanche.
Sauvé's a rookie and can be forgiven for having a tough first season here. Abisher's been great, and I think the Avalanche will give him a chance to start the playoffs. When people suggest they're going after a goaltender, it's just because they don't believe the Avalanche will leave themselves open if Abisher gets hurt or doesn't succeed in the playoffs without a sufficient backup that might win them a cup. Because this is a team built to win a Stanley Cup, not just win a round or two. Grant Sopel trying to fight through to the net. Morrison passed outside the blue line to Matias Olin. The Canucks will have to retreat. Derek Morris. Kurt Sauer. And Milan Hayduk tips the puck through center. Hayduk and Sakic back on the ice. Joe Sakic. Fans are searching for things to applaud here. It's amazing how the intensity dies when the score is 5-0.
That was Todd Bertuzzi that brought some fans to life there and a big hit for Mark Crawford. Tony Granato is going to enjoy this one. This is the hit on Sauer that brought some clapping from the fans here at GM Place. You're right, they're looking for something. And Granato's got an interesting job as an opposition coach now. Who does he get on the ice to make sure there's enough toughness in case things go awry?
The Sedins and Jarkko Ruutu. A tip by Daniel, searching for the puck, a backhander, he couldn't get it through. Another shot, and that's blocked. Carlos scratched his down on the ice, I think made a couple of saves inadvertently. And Abisher couldn't get to the puck, and Daniel Sedin couldn't bang it home. Henrik and Daniel pinned to the boards. Riku Hall pushed the puck in behind the net. Daniel Sedin for Henrik. Ruutu fights Skrastins to get to the front of the goal. In comes Wade Brookbank. His backhander hit a skate. Daniel takes a shot. That didn't get through. Another blocked shot, this time by Adam Foote. He can't hold on to the puck. It's knocked off the side of the net by Brookbank, who came back in off the blue line again. Now there's Ruutu challenging Steve Moore. And Moore declines the invitation. Steve Moore declined an invitation from Matt Cook last week. There's Brad May with a hit on Steve Moore. And now maybe some scores will be settled here. Moore is being challenged by Brad May. Korea, meantime, heads for the net, and his backhander is stopped by Johan Hedberg. Teemu Selänne can't find the handle in front of the net, and Johan Hedberg stopped him. Korea. Sharp angled shot by Darby Henriksen is stopped. In the meantime, Steve Moore had headed for the bench, so he'd only be challenged twice on that shift. Here's a chance in front. Brad May scores. And then he goes over and gives Abisher a push. A 5-1 game. May wanted a goal and a scrap on the same shift. Will Trevor Linden get his milestone assist here? Here's his shoot-in. Cook, May, and Trevor Linden should have point number 674 and the all-time lead in Vancouver Canuck points.
So is Brad May going after Abisher, or was he trying to get the puck?
Bittersweet for Trevor Linden, who's waited a dozen games to get the point. Matt Cook and Brad May into the net. Trevor Linden with the second assist on the shoot hit. And we await the announcement of the goal. Trevor Linden should have that milestone point. Colorado 5, Vancouver 1, back after this.
Goaltenders in Prince George, B.C. should avoid Patrick Snell, star winger in the Snell Hockey League, where competition is so fierce it can turn son against father. Sweet move, Patrick.
Backyard hockey is more than a game, and the Home Depot is more than a store, which is why we're proud to help build rinks and communities and backyards all across Canada.
For the first time ever, the United States has become the first nation to walk on the moon.
Houston, I'm just gonna try and hit this golf ball.
Huh? Uh-oh. Ottawa, we have a problem. about that, eh?
Still haven't officially announced the milestone point for Trevor Linden, and you can understand why he doesn't seem too excited about it right now. His team trailing 5-1 in a game that is a battle for top spot in the Northwest Division, and the Avalanche have a 1-point lead and a 4-goal lead in the game. Linden out with May and Cook.
Fourth of the season, scored by number 10, Brad May. The assist to number 24, Matt Cook. And to number 16, Trevor Linden. The time, 7:24. May, his fourth of the season, from Cook and Linden at 7:24.
That's a smart move by linesman Mike Civic.
Not great.
Find a hole in the ice to create a delay, and Trevor just gave him a tap on the ankles to say thanks.
You know what? There was no hole in the ice there. He just did that. That was brilliant.
And Joe Sakic backed off as well.
Absolutely.
In a real class act. That's a tough time for Trevor Linden.
Yeah.
Not one to spend much time thinking about personal accolades and accomplishments. He reaches a wonderful milestone with his team trailing 5-1 in a very important game. Linden again passes off to Sokol. Sokol to the front of the net. May again scores! And May goes right back after Abisher in a repeat performance. And suddenly the Canucks are working their way back into this game.
And Brad May is going to get a penalty this time. He went right after Abisher and had a chat with him. Give him the raspberry, but what a good play by Linden to Sokol, and a better play by Brad May with good hands. Brad May with the last two goals for the Vancouver Canucks is all of a sudden giving them some life. This is the number one goal. Good hands by May. There's the chat. Hey, Mr. Abisher, I'm in your face. And here's the second one, a good drag and pull, and watch here. He goes right back after David Abisher.
.724 and .816, two goals, 2 points for Trevor Linden. And now Brad May gets a penalty, and Trevor wants to know what for. And it's not often you see a picture of the goal scorer in the penalty box before the next faceoff.
Well, Brad May is having one of these games where he has just decided, I'm not saying single-handedly, but that he is going to will this game forward. And there's a time where he's had a scrap, two scraps now against Peter Worrell. He's scored two goals. Gordie Howe hat trick here pretty quick.
Now he's trying to drag his team right back into this. And Trevor Linden, after going 12 games without a point, is on a streak with two assists in 49 seconds here. And Vancouver's within three. And they're a team that can score some goals, so that offers some hope as Brad May tries to drag them right back into this with some help from Trevor Linden.
Okay, so we got a 5-on-5 here. What happened there? 10-minute?
So he didn't get a minor penalty. He's been given a misconduct.
Yeah.
10-minute misconduct. Here's Milan Hejduk with a shot, and Hedberg, who must close the door, does on Milan Hejduk, and back comes Trevor Linden. He's got Matt Cook and Jarkko Ruutu with him. Linden looks to the net, looks to Cook, and he couldn't tip the pass. Here's Olin with a big hit. A punishing blow on Alex Tanque. And there's a penalty being called on the play.
I don't know if it's on Olin. I think it's going to be on Jarkko Ruutu for high sticking here.
It is not on Olin for the hit on Tangay. Indeed, it's Ruutu that's headed for the penalty box. This time, Vancouver will be shorthanded.
What a good hit by Matthias Olin, who steps right up on Tangay and just nails him. That's a great hit.
And a penalty on Ruutu for bumping Abisher.
There it is.
So Vancouver's shorthanded. And an inopportune time where there's some real life in their lineup all of a sudden. May gets a pair of goals, a huge hit by Olin. A three-goal game with lots of time left. An interference call on Ruutu, and Colorado's on the power play here. Kariya, Konowalczyk, and Solani. Hedberg out to play the puck. Lyles meets it along the boards, trying to keep it in. Salo in a battle here with Konowalczyk, and in comes Teemu Selänne to get the puck. Backhands into the corner to Paul Kariya. Behind the net to Konowalczyk. Looking back to Morris at the right point. Lyles is on the left point. Morris, one-timer, great save by Hedberg. Kicked out the right leg and made a nice save on Derek Morris. Lyles tips the puck through on a Vancouver change. Selänne to Sacking, and a hot shot goes up off the glass. Joe Sakic back out on the power play here, has scored once in the game. Alex Tangay off the boards, leaves the puck for Joe Sakic. Solani's in the slot, Morris with a shot, Hedberg stopped that too. Sakic with Tangay and Solani. Morris fakes the shot, over to Lyles. Lyles to Morris, Sakic's parked in front of the net. Teemu Selänne along the boards, checked by Sopel. In comes Allen to take Sakic, in comes Linden to take the puck, and he sends it down the ice.
You know, Jim, in the context of this game, on what's happened here, in a little bit of history, all of a sudden, Brian Allen and the Vancouver Canucks are not letting up at all, and the best players of the Colorado Avalanche. Allen just went after Sakic. Obviously, it was Matthias Olin that went after Tangay. Whoops. And this is going to be a very interesting game because it's not like they're just going after Peter Worrell.
These teams clearly don't like each other. And it looked like in a 5-1 game they were going to try and start settling scores. Now, if Vancouver gets another one, it changes the complexion of the game as well, because suddenly they're getting right back into it. And here comes Matthias Olin. Fires a shot. Rebound. Cook misses. Keane can't get it. Jarkko Ruutu's after the puck. And the play is stopped, and Matt Cook's going to get a penalty. The Canucks are going after David Abisher, the goaltender. May's been in the penalty box, so is Ruutu. Now Cook is going in a 5-2 game.
Every day, you get a fresh start at life.
Start fresh every day. With a smile, I'm on my way. I want to start right with a great taste in every bite.
Start your day fresh with breakfast at Subway. Egg sandwiches made fresh with no greasy taste on fresh baked bread. Your choice of bacon, ham, Western or cheese, plus your favorite Subway toppings.
Start fresh every day. Subway, start fresh.
Some people listen to themselves rather than listen to what others say. These people don't come along very often. But when they do, they remind us that there is no can't, won't, or impossible. They remind us that it's okay to believe impossible is nothing.
Take you out, son.
When the Coors Light Brewing Company puts its mind to something, we follow through. You said you wanted a beer that would be ice cold. Done. You said you wanted a beer with an easy drinking taste. So be it. You said you wanted to meet those girls over there.
You can do that?
Hey, we make beer, not miracles. Coors Light, the silver bullet.
Here's the penalty on Matt Cook.
Watch Cook go straight into Abisher there. gets his stick up and nails Abisher. Otherwise, I think he could have had a gone to it for a case that it was just getting bumped in. Trevor Linden with a nice ovation here.
He acknowledged the ovation as well during the television timeout. A video tribute was shown on the in-house score clock, and Trevor stood up on the bench and acknowledged a second standing ovation. Two assists, he's at 675, and he doesn't have to worry about answering questions about that after tonight. And the puck is cleared over the glass. Did it deflect? It's going to be another penalty against Johan Hedberg.
Budget Brake and Mufflers having a half-price sale. Save one half on Rebestos brake pads and shoes, and one half on Gorlick mufflers. Sale in Saturday.
This is a bizarre game. There's a lot of weird things going on here. Now, another penalty to Johan Hedberg, a second for delay of game. He'll argue this was deflected. But Stephen Walkham says no. Vancouver's going to be short two men again. For a minute, 44 seconds, it's a 5-on-3 for Colorado.
Yeah, Stephen Walkham was down in the corner. Johan Hedberg says that it went off a Colorado stick. But it doesn't matter at this point. Linden comes in to take the faceoff. Here it is again. It's hard to tell.
Avalanche got the draw. Morris. Sackett. Kariya. Avalanche trying to quell this Vancouver comeback bid. Sackett to Morris to Hayduk. Stopped by Johan Hedberg. A bouncing puck. Salo couldn't clear it. Derek Morris to Milan Hayduk. Derek Morris again. Kariya's in front. So is Sackett to Morris. He shoots. He scores. No goal. Waved off.
Yeah, Tange tangles up with Johan Hedberg. So is this goalie interference?
Now it could be call off the goal and a penalty. It could be just no goal.
Watch right here. There. So he interferes with Tange, but he is tripped up. Looks like it's just going to be no goal.
No goal, no penalty.
Mark Crawford's upset.
He wants a penalty.
And you know what Crow is upset at there is that...
Here's Paul Kariya moving into the 5-on-3. Back in front to him on a return pass. And he couldn't finish it off. Joe Sackett on the 5-on-3 as they set up again. Derek Morris, Kariya's in front of the net. Hayduk, Tange there as well. Morris to Sackett as they close in. 5-on-3. Alex Tange, Derek Morris, Milan Hayduk, Morris, Hayduk. One timer. That was stopped easily by Hedberg, who played it perfectly. Keane, Salo, and Olin, the penalty killers for Vancouver. Hayduk to Morris. Faked the shot. Over to Paul Kariya. Tange screening again. Sackett to Morris. He shoots, scores. Deflected this time in front off Alex Tange, who was a little further away from the goaltender. And it's a 6-2 Avalanche lead.
Yeah, might have went right off of Mike Keane, too. Keane went down to block a shot. And Mark Crawford was upset because Stephen Walkham went over and talked to Tony Granato, but wouldn't talk to him there off of Keane enough.
Tange doesn't get it. Morris will.
So it goes off the sort of the back of the leg of Mike Keane, unfortunately, and goes through the top corner over top of Hedberg.
So Vancouver had what looked to be a spirited comeback going here at two goals in 49 seconds by Brad May and then got into penalty trouble. Ruutu, then Cook. Ruutu and Cook after David Abisher. Here comes Lyles with a shot, and another penalty is being called, this time against Colorado. Morris from Sackett and Kariya is the scoring play at 12-16 for Colorado, and now another penalty. Murph.
Watch Future Sports Pacific telecast, and you could win an all-inclusive week-long trip for two to the Holiday Inn Port of Arda, courtesy of Sunquest Vacations and Holiday Inn Port of Arda. Shop and swipe at Safeway, and you could be our winner.
Steve Konowalczuk, the latest player in the penalty box.
It's high sticking on Brian Allen. See right in the, just the left of your screen, right there.
Still 34 seconds to go in the penalty that was handed Johan Hedberg. So the teams are 4-on-4, and in half a minute, Vancouver will go to the power play. Here's Carlos Krastic, foots on the other side. A weak shot stopped by Hedberg. Sopel up the boards to Daniel Sedin with Henrik. Ruutu set to join them out of the penalty box. Brian Allen's up on the rush. Can't get the puck back to the front of the net. Good play by Carlos Krastic to steer him wide. Ruutu's out of the penalty box. Vancouver's on a power play for a minute 22 seconds. Here's Henrik Sedin. Olin comes onto the ice and is back at the point and takes the pass, looks to the net, drills a shot, rebound is loose. Daniel couldn't get to it. Sopel, Olin again, big crowd in front of David Avisher. Here's Sopel, moves into the middle of the ice and passes off to Matthias Olin. Ruutu's providing the screen in front, battling there. Now he moves off a little bit and then heads back to the front of the goal. Sopel, into Henrik Sedin. Olin sneaks in off the left side. Sopel takes his shot. Blocked by Joe Sakic, who tried to get away, and Sopel took the puck back and dumps it in. Ruutu takes the man, but the puck is cleared by Adam Foote down the ice. The penalty killers scramble to get to the bench to change. So does the power play. Marcus Naslund, Todd Bertuzzi, and Brendan Morrison come on. Matthias Olin shoots the puck in. They'll overload the right side. Naslund's interfered with by Nikolishin, so he can't get to the puck. Paul Kariya trying to clear the puck, can't get it by Marcus Naslund. He's got Baumgartner over at the right point, feeds the puck into Brendan Morrison. Behind the net to Bertuzzi. Naslund heads for the front of the net. Morrison is open, takes a shot. Avisher stopped that. 10 seconds to go in the power play. Baumgartner, Matthias Olin, back to Nolan Baumgartner, to Marcus Naslund. Bertuzzi goes to the front of the net. Naslund to Brendan Morrison. Penalty to Connor Walchuk is over. Teams are 5-on-5. Naslund to the front of the net. Avisher stops the puck and smothers it. For a stop in play. 6-2 the score. The Avalanche leads on Molson Canucks hockey.
Introducing the new Chevrolet Optra. It's stylish, even when you're not.
We've been coming here for years. Suddenly, everybody has a laptop. What gives?
It's a hotspot.
A hotspot?
A hotspot. Broadband. Wireless. A tipping point. One hotspot, a blip. 10, a novelty. Then the game of business changes. Billions of dollars fly through the air.
Billions?
Billions.
Watch your head.
How's our security?
Been saving my scratch to buy my dream whip. I'm not about the luxury, not even a bit. Square's not my deal, gotta have the right feel. I need to roll in something a little more real. Now this classic ride fills me with pride, and I'm itching to cruise in my fresh new bruise. Yeah, I bought these wheels because I've been eating McDeal.
The Everyday McDeal menu. Get a different deal every day of the week for only $1.69 plus tax.
McDonald's. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it.
A curious game, to be sure. You never know what to expect. I guess that's why people buy tickets and why we all sit down and watch this game, because you can't predict what's going to happen. We expected this one to be much closer. 6-2 Avalanche. With all sorts of different twists and turns here, some fights. In the second period, a couple of goals by Brad May, and the Canucks have really been going after goaltender David Avisher. Here's Sammy Salo from center. Bout after Connor Walchuk. Darby Hendrickson starts out. Steve Moore run into by Brian Allen. And the puck got up onto the Avalanche bench, and Steve Moore is challenged again, this time by Tyler Bout. A couple of score and win winners thanks to Brad May tonight on behalf of the Safeway Score and Win Contest and Viva Paper Towels. Zora Riddell of Coquitlam's won a Midwax wood finishing system. Congratulations. And our next score and win winner, courtesy of Safeway and the Viva Paper Towels, is Liz Choquette of Vancouver, who's won the VTech 5.8 gigahertz digital cordless phone with answering system.
And about every time that Canucks tend to go after Steve Moore, Peter Worrell comes out on the ice as Mark Crawford looks on. This time it's Worrell and Bertuzzi come together.
Here's Worrell trying to get away from Bertuzzi, and he's hit hard by Salo. That, folks, is like felling a redwood tree.
Oh, he's hurt.
Worrell is hurt. Salo dumped the puck in, heads for the bench on a change. Kurt Sauer up the boards. Matthias Olin had Steve Moore in his sights, didn't he? Oh, man, he wanted him. And then the puck took a detour. Here's Olin back after Moore, runs into the boards. Henrik Sedin gets the puck across the ice. Brent Sopel with Daniel Sedin dumps the puck in. Adam Foote is back. Boy, this is a game where you better have your head on a swivel, right? Heads up in this one.
Especially if your name starts with Steve.
Trevor Linden up the middle to Cook. He's on a 2-on-0. Cook shot wide by Jarkko Ruutu. Cook and Ruutu 2-on-0. And Ruutu missed the net. Sopel takes the shot. Cook screening. Puck was deflected to the corner. Emu Solani got the puck to the blue line. Ruutu keeps it in. In for Matt Cook again, in behind the defense of Lyles and Skrastins. Skrastins gets the puck and moves it ahead. Tange got away from Olin. Sakic trying to get into the play. Linden interferes with him. Tange holds up on a change. Gets the puck to Milan Hayduk. Joe Sakic looks for Tange in the slot. Now passes over to Adam Foote at a sharp angle. Feeds the puck into the slot. Tange trying to get control of it and can't. Matthias Olin comes up with the puck. Hayduk takes a run at Olin as the puck is cleared to center.
Introducing the new GMC Canyon, with an inline five-cylinder that's more powerful than any V6 in its class.
Worrell and Bertuzzi right off the faceoff, a little hack and whack, and watch this hit.
Yeah, that's a good hit. That's a good clean hit. You know, Salo steps into Worrell, and he's just so big that he gets it in the upper thigh area. Looked like a Charlie horse. And again, there's a bit of a theme happening here. The Canucks are really going after the top players of the Avs. When I say going after, I mean good solid hits, but the tendency previous to this is to let up a little bit on players like Joe Sakic and Alex Tange.
Here's Marcus Naslund, on whose behalf some of these hits and challenges have been thrown. Here's Bertuzzi to the net, pushed by Nikolishin into the post after he danced around Adam Foote. And Bertuzzi will plead his case here for a penalty against Colorado as he was grabbed onto to no avail.
Now this is a power forward. Todd Bertuzzi powers around his man, and it's Adam Foote. And then there's the hit.
Budget Brake and Mufflers having a half price sale. Save one half on Asbestos brake pads and shoes, and one half on Gorlick mufflers. Sale in Saturday.
It was actually Bertuzzi who grabbed onto Foote and spun him around, and then he was knocked into the post by Andre Nikolishin. Derek Morris to Riku Hall. Tips the puck in deep. Baumgartner's back. The outlet tipped through by Henrik. To Ruutu to Daniel Sedin. Just a couple of minutes to go in the second period. An eventful second period, to be sure. Henrik along the boards, Jarkko Ruutu. Mugged by Derek Morris. Daniel comes in and gets the puck. Hacked at by Darby Henriksen. Brian Allen came in off the blue line to Henrik at a sharp angle. He couldn't put it in. Here's Brian Allen to the front of the net. And Ruutu was all tied up by Kurt Sauer. Henrik behind the net. Battles Derek Morris. Ruutu's in this as well. Morris knocked down. He moves the puck ahead. And out comes Hall. Daniel Sedin. Through a hit as play continues. And now he's wrestling.
And the play has not been blown down yet.
That was Daniel on Darby Henriksen.
Look at this. Too many men on the ice.
And they're caught.
And if you didn't have a second referee, you wouldn't have caught that one.
Or any of the stuff that was going on. Steve Walkham at one end was watching the battle between Daniel Sedin and Darby Henriksen. And the other official, Dennis LaRue, picked up Paul Kariya hurtling over the boards to try and get out of the play.
Oh, boy, there's a lot of players on the ice here. Look at Correa trying to get
up. Six there right now. Yeah. There goes Paul flying onto the bench, but caught before he could get there. Daniel Sedin on Darby Hendrickson.
And in the foreground or the background there, you can see Jarkko Ruutu getting tripped up. So Hendrickson and Sedin go at it. Ruutu is tripped up. No call there. But the Canucks will have a penalty. A power play off a Colorado, too many men on the ice penalty, a minute 21 to go. It's a 6-2 game, and it is a weird one.
The Avalanche have had a half a dozen power plays in the game. Vancouver's Matias Olin. Center decides to carry the puck into the attacking zone. He trips up at the blue line. Bertuzzi goes in after Skrastin. Sallow from the point. Brendan Morrison. Olin sneaking in off the left point towards the front of the net. Bertuzzi screening in his office. Here's Marcus Naslund. Looks for Bertuzzi. He's got Sallow over in the corner. Olin back at the blue line. Morrison to Olin. Waits. Takes the screenshot. Tipped wide of the net. Sallow races after the puck, bumps hard with Joe Sakic along the boards in the last 35 seconds of the second period. Marcus Naslund in behind the net to Todd Bertuzzi. He collides with Skrastin. Morrison to Sallow, looks to the net, over to Olin. One timer deflected off the skate of Connor Walchuk wide. Brendan Morrison now, Skrastin and Bertuzzi battle. Naslund from behind the net, tried to wrap around and lost the handle on the puck with under 20 seconds to go in the period. Naslund to Olin. He shoots. Abisher the save. The rebound. Morrison can't put it in. Just wide. Sakic gets a hold of the puck and clears it with 10 seconds to go in the second period. Olin to center. Morrison to Sopel. And that play was offside on the pass through to Brendan Morrison from Matias Olin with 3 seconds to go in the period. Dan Murphy.
Thanks, Jim. Canucks collectible cards and album available at BC Save on Foods and Overweighty Foods. Collect all 24. You may even find a signed Naslund, Bertuzzi, or Morrison card in select packs.
Tony Granato and the Avalanche with a 6-2 lead in Vancouver. And killing off a penalty here, but first of all, going to the second intermission, Vancouver will have a power play for 38 seconds to start the third. What an interesting game. The Vancouver Canucks showed an awful lot more life in period number two. They filled the penalty box. They got a couple of goals, but still trail by four. CD Plus, greatest hits coming up in our second intermission.
The second period is brought to you by The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
CD Plus Greatest Hits, brought to you by CD Plus, more than just a music store. 31-year-old spark plug Darren McCarty is a physical presence in Motown.
Lose yourself in the vast selection of CDs and DVDs CD Plus has to offer, including...
Love Home!
They bought the house.
It's the sweet little old lady that lives upstairs.
They met...
Ooh.
The neighbor.
That was your... I think it's your couch.
She's a freak of nature!
I could have fallen right through.
Duplex.
Now over 100 locations across Canada or shop online at cdplus.com. CD Plus, more than just a music store.
At 6'1", 210 pounds, McCarty is a great hitter with a big on-ice presence. Noted for his toughness, he can also score, evidenced by his career-high 19 goals in 96-97. A native of Burnaby, BC, McCarty is a fearless competitor who has won the hearts of fans in Hockey Town with his all-out fearless style. One part heart, one part grit, the 31-year-old has made his mark in hockey's hotbed. Another installment of CD Plus Greatest Hits. CD Plus, more than just a music store.
Honey? I have to speak with you, sweetie. Look both ways before you cross the street. Clean behind your ears. Don't talk with your mouth full. Never run with scissors. Floss, wear sunscreen, take the SATs. Buy low, sell high. Marry for love the first time and money the second. Here's your passport. Come give mommy a hug. Oh, that's enough.
5 minutes isn't ideal for everything, but it's perfect for Keno. With a draw every 5 minutes in pubs and lotto stores, Keno is frequent, fast, fun.
think fresh. With Panago's salads, tropical pizzas, and our new thin crust with 3.6 grams of carbs per slice. Only from Panago.
At Coast Capital Savings, we take pride in exceeding expectations. That's why Stephen here has volunteered to help a customer care for his pet.
I did?
So it's just one pill?
Yeah, and thanks. I mean, all I wanted was an RSP.
It's our pleasure. Oh, Stephen! Other end.
At Bell Mobility, we know it's annoying when your cell phone doesn't work. So last year, our engineers like Stu here drove more than 1 million kilometers testing the network. Here's Stu in Halifax. And here he is in Kingston. And Yellowknife. And Victoria. Just give me a second here.
Second intermission, brought to you by Blockbuster Video. Make it a Blockbuster night.
This news update brought to you by Home Hardware, where help is close to home.
We're feeling close to home. Everybody else at GM Place gave
Trevor Linden.
Trevor Linden,
yes, congratulations.
So,
Jack's cheering him on too. Mr. Canuck, drink
Jack
that. Drink to that.
Doesn't even like hockeys over there. I'm just kidding, Jack. We want to bring you up to date on the game between Detroit and Tampa Bay. First, a word from a certain Red Wing defenseman.
I haven't been here all season. It's almost like making another trade, for that matter.
Filling in.
All right, Darian Hatcher. He'd missed 64 games, had some problems with his knees, but he is back just in time for the postseason run, hauled down there by one Martin St. Louis, who's after a scoring title in the National Hockey League. Yzerman sending it ahead. Thomas Helmstrom will barrel through and beat Nikolai Habibul, and Detroit takes the 1-0 lead. They want to take over first place in the NHL, but look at that giveaway by Chris Chelios. Three guys come down the ice, and wow, two different saves by Manny Legacy. He won't save this one, as Peter Labardius would say. Frederick Modine finally at the doorstep. He gets his 23rd, a 1-1 game, and that's exactly how things finished. So the Lightning clinched the Southeast Division with 91 points. Detroit has 90 as they battled for top spot in the league. Robert Lang, by the way, didn't play in the third period for an undisclosed reason. He trails St. Louis in the scoring race.
Maybe he's traded back. Ottawa and Washington. Peter Bondra back in D.C. for the first time since the trade. He has 9 points in 9 games for the Sens. First period, Sean Van Allen to Chris Phillips. And the defenseman will get the fourth of the year to match the jersey number 1-0. Ottawa, then Marian Hossa going to work. The wraparound is no good, as pretty as it is, but who's there to clean it up? Ooh, Martin Havlat. People don't like him lately. 26 of the year, 2-0 since. Olaf Kolzig on the bench, saying he's out with the flu, but of course, rumored to be going anywhere. Colorado, Vancouver, perhaps, who knows? Second period, Trent Woodfield, it's a post. Stephen Pete, and does not on the rebound. Caps trail at 2-1, then the Sens on the power play. Alfredson to Wade Redden. Yes. 15th of the year, 3-1 Sens. Third period, Sens on the power play going to work. Alfredson to Mike Fisher. He's got three. The Sens have another win by the final of 4-1. There was no one in Washington to watch and to welcome Peter Bondra back. It's an ugly situation there as the fire sale continues. And maybe tomorrow, Olaf Kolzig will be the final link in that fire sale. We'll see you after the game with plenty more on the trades and Trevor Linden.
This news update is brought to you by Home Hardware, where help is close to home. Canadian Club Best Shots is here. Log on to sportsnet.ca now and choose what play you think is the best shot of the season. By entering, you'll be eligible for the grand prize of a private box suite for you and 9 friends to cheer on your home team, all thanks to Canadian Club and Sportsnet. Other prizes include a 27-inch digital television and Sportsnet prize packs. Contest ends April 5th, so don't miss out. Enter Canadian Club Best Shots, brought to you by Canadian Club. 151 countries, one ride. No purchase necessary, must be legal 18 age.
The 2004 Toyota 4Runner.
where will it take you?
Think any of these top scorers ever earned $1 million for a single goal? In their dreams. But you can with Kraft. Right now, you could instantly win a chance to shoot to win up to $1 million. Look for specially marked Kraft and Christie products to get an access code. Then play online at shoottowin.ca. And you could be next to shoot to win up to $1 million with Kraft. Just like Vincent Lowe from Surrey, BC. Not bad for a rookie.
You're not a little fish in a big pond. You're not small or unimportant. At H&R Block, we treat you like the important person that you are. We're going to tell you what your return is going to cost up front. We'll help you get the biggest refund that you're entitled to, and we don't expect you to pay us until you're satisfied. See, we don't treat you like a little fish. We're going to treat you like a whale.
No, if a whale was a fish.
The H&R Block Advantage.
We're back at the Lotto Super 7 Shopping Network for the super rich. Ivana, welcome.
Thank you. How often does it happen? You open your junk drawer and hello, diamonds and rubies are everywhere.
It is so true, but just what are you supposed to do with them all?
Well, what you do, you get to be jeweler. Mm-hmm. Come in, darling.
Oh, beautiful.
Look at her kitten's eyes, pure sapphire.
Now, I can do this myself.
Sure, if you didn't have servants.
Not only has City Fido achieved success beyond our wildest dreams, it has spawned a whole new industry. City Fido home and mobile service with unlimited local calls in the lower mainland for just $45 a month. Regrettably, only from Fido.
There have been a lot of rumors surrounding Chris Pronger lately. Here's Tui Noarchu. He has not asked for a trade from the Blues, and he'll be Jim Houston's next guest on Snapshots tomorrow at 6 o'clock. Darby Hendrickson joins me now. And Darby, you went from a pretty good rivalry with the Canucks and Wild to the Canucks and Avalanche. This is a game you really want to keep your head up in, isn't it?
It is. I think whenever I've played against Vancouver, it seems like the last 5 years they've always played extremely hard. And certainly with Minnesota, we had those type of games in the playoffs as well, and it's no different with Colorado. So we've had some bounces tonight, but we know that's not always indicative of the score.
You're now part of the Avalanche's three fastest goals in franchise history. Let's take a look at the one you scored.
Well, I was actually on the wing on that shift, and Derek Morris there just made a great pass. Just had a little opening to get through, and I kind of tripped, but fortunately just found a corner and it snuck in.
What do you do now in the third period? They had some life, a big power play goal by Derek Morris. Do you just look to get momentum back on your side?
Well, we have to reestablish some of the things we did early. We may not get rewarded in the goal department like we always did, but forechecking and getting on their defensemen are huge things for us. So we have to work on that and just get back to playing honest, solid hockey.
Good luck down the stretch.
Thank you.
Former Canuck Darby Hendrickson on the scoring tonight for the Colorado Avalanche. And there are some single tickets left for Darby's old team. March 10th, the Minnesota Wild. Call Ticketmaster at 280-4400. Through two periods, the Canucks are on the board. Both their goals from Brad May, but still trail by 4 goals. The third period is coming up in a moment from GM Place.
The second intermission, brought to you by Blockbuster Video. Make it a Blockbuster night.
It's the hottest contest on ice. Safeway $1 million score and win. Swipe your Safeway club card to enter. You could win $1 million or an incredible brand name prize, including a Minwax wood finishing system featuring Minwax water-based stains. Minwax water-based stains provide rich, even stain color and long-lasting beauty. They're easy to use, fast drying, and clean up with water. Available in 66 custom decorator and wood tone colors. Shop at Safeway today for your chance to win. Safeway, giving our best.
Only from Polaris can you get the Sportsman 700 Twin EFI, the world's first 4x4 ATV with EFI, or the Predator 500, named best-in-class sport ATV in 2004, or the Polaris all-terrain pickup, the one named 2004 ATV of the year by ATV Magazine. And now, to celebrate Polaris's 50th anniversary, choose a free Warn winch or pay nothing for a year. Only from Polaris and only for a limited time.
Introducing Molson Ultra, the only lower carb beer that's not a light beer.
2.5 grams of carbs, 97 calories, and still brewed full strength. Molson Ultra. Real beer, fewer carbs.
Let's say you're in a hurry and you want to get from here to there, or maybe from there to here. It's simple. With over 300 convenient locations, National Car Rentals, wherever you need us to be. So no matter where you're going, we're here for you. And we're also there for you. National Car Rental.
Been saving my scratch to buy my dream whip. I'm not about the luxury, not even a bit. Square's not my deal, gotta have the right feel. I need to roll in something a little more real. Now this classic ride fills me with pride, and I'm itching to cruise in my fresh new bruise. Yeah, I bought these wheels cause I've been eating McDeal.
The Everyday McDeal menu. Get a different deal every day of the week for only $1.69 plus tax.
McDonald's, ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it.
Flat tire on my van. I think my wife parallel parks front first.
No time to get the tire fixed with the kids and everything like that, but I headed over to Cal Tire.
Nah, it was about a minute till closing. A leaky tire isn't safe. You can't watch the clock on that.
And the bay doors opened up and hooked up all the hoses outside, and I've just never had service that good. Nice to find a place that 1 minute before closing still means that you're open.
Cal Tire, true service.
Welcome back to General Motors Place. A most interesting evening with the Avalanche leading 6-2. We head to the third period. And a look at the scoring summary of the second period brought to you by Cal Tire, true service. Brad May has 2 goals and 2 fights. Gordie Howe would be proud of that. Trevor Linden has points number 674 and 675. Here's some of the fistic action, May and Worrell.
This is the first fight, the second fight here. Pointed out, 2 goals, 2 fights, 20 minutes of penalties does Brad May have. Here's the first goal. John Michael Lyle is bumped off the puck by Matt Cook. Here's the second goal. Good move by May. He goes right back after Abisher and chats with him. And that's where he gets his 10-minute misconduct.
A goal and a misconduct in the same play. If Brad May should score one more goal to register a hat trick, a lucky Safeway shopper will instantly win a prize package consisting of all 8 score and win brand name prizes. What if he has 3 goals and 3 fights? Is there anything more they can win? Dave Mussolati's in the penalty box. 38 seconds remaining in his penalty. And the Canucks have been shorthanded a lot in recent games. And it was their undoing in Detroit, a 5-on-3 goal that put them down 2-0. Tonight, 6 power plays for the Avalanche and Mark Crawford's crew on their 2nd power play tonight. And I wonder if the score settling will continue here in this third period.
A little bit of different line match here. We've got Bertuzzi taking the center at the center ice with Naslin and Daniel City.
They move in on a power play and try and set up. Daniel Bertuzzi lost his helmet. He heads for the front of the net and meets old friend Adam Foote. A pass for Olin was deflected by Nikolishin out to center. 10 seconds to go in the power play. Bertuzzi tipped the puck through to Naslin. There's another penalty coming up against the Avalanche here as Naslin throws the puck into the middle. Sakic touches it. Just 3 seconds left in the Solani penalty, and Vancouver gets a very short 5-on-3. It's a tripping call. In the power play, Vancouver can draw closer.
Yeah, it was Nikolishin heading to the bench. To see him trip up Daniel Sedin right there in front of the bench. And that's the trip call made. So Canucks with a short, as you pointed out, Jim, 5-on-3, 3 seconds to go, and Solani's penalty for too many men on the ice. He served him.
You wouldn't want to take a penalty like that and have it cost you a game. Ooh. 6-2 game, probably not going to have too many people saying anything to him. Sopel with a quick shot, rebound, just about scored 5-on-3. They just about had something to say about that Nikolishin penalty. He You just get this feeling since Vancouver came alive in the second period that this game is a long ways from over in many different departments. Some beyond the score. Here's Paul Kariya darting out of his own end. He's got Dan Hynode with him, two on one. Kariya shoots Hedberg to save, but it got by him. He stopped it, but not completely. And Paul Kariya with a hot shot has made this a 7-2 game.
Well, that'll be a big goal for Kariya. A real confidence goal for Paul Kariya. And it was Matias Olin got caught way down in the corner. Well, that just goes right through the glove of Hedberg. And that allowed the two-on-one and lots of time and space for Kariya to get a shot.
7-2, Paul Kariya joins the scoring rush tonight. And it's a shorthanded goal for the Avalanche. Their seventh shorthanded goal of the season, the ninth for number nine, Kariya. And Vancouver continues on the power play here.
Brad Mann, the power play, Jim, in front of the net.
And he tipped the puck just wide, and he's after the rebound. It's loose in front of the net. Darby Hendrickson clears it. Abisher took a little swing at Brad May as he skated through the crease on his way outside the blue line. Henrik. Daniel Sedin had Hynode run into him and fall over. It's just impossible for one person to have enough eyes to see all of the things that are going on in this game all over the ice. Sopel dumps the puck in from center. Abisher's out to play it. Deflected by Henrik Sedin. Now Adam Foote gets the puck out to Dan Hynode. And Hynode just tripped Henrik Sedin at the bench.
And May goes after Hynode. So what's the penalty? Brad May is going to get a penalty and not Hynode.
And Brad said indeed headed back to the penalty box. Hynode on Henrik, and in comes Brad May with a whack in the back of the head. Why Iota?
Looked like Hynode was angry at first and then saw May, who has been a pretty tough customer in tonight's game.
Penalty comes 2 minutes and 20 seconds into the third period with 16 seconds remaining in the collision penalty. So Colorado will go on the power play here very shortly. Kariya passes off to Kurt Sauer. Dave Mussolini. Sauer. They're awaiting the arrival of Nikolishin from the penalty box as Trevor Linden gets a hold of the puck. And he passes back to Matias Olin. Penalty's over. Colorado has a man advantage here for a minute and 40 seconds. A long shot down the ice on Abisher. Lyles is back. Kariya dishes in front of his own net. Derek Morris starts out with some jump three on two. Solani with him, and he dropped it right through his legs. Linden back the other way to Jarkko Ruutu. His backhand pass is over for Brent Sopel, but Adam Foote stepped in and Sopel tripped over him. Foote leads the power play into the attacking zone. Milan Haidu. Alex Tanguay meets up with Brent Sopel. Brendan Morrison can't clear the puck, kept in by Skrastins. Here's Joe Sakic to Haidu. He scores. 8-2 Colorado.
Now this is just a nice one-touch shot off a great pass. Puck doesn't go out on the top of the blue line, near the blue line, creates a two-on-one down low. That's a time where Brian Allen doesn't want to turn his back. He wants to make sure that he's watching the puck and watching where Sakic's going to put the puck. And with a split second, Hedrick's able to pop it home.
Carlos Skrastins made the play at the blue line against Brendan Morrison to keep the puck in. He should get the second assist. And Colorado is 2-for-7 on the power play. Thanks to the goal by Milan Hajduk, his second of the game, his 34th of the season. Sakic has another point. And it is 8-2 Colorado.
Jim, in that last play, John Michael Lyles got hit by Trevor Linden, went to the bench and is still sore on the bench. Follow that a little bit.
Lyles has been very good, but preparing for the playoffs, you wonder if at 180 pounds and in his size, how he'll hold up during the marathon of the playoffs. Now, the comparison has been made to Brian Rafalski of New Jersey, but Rafalski has a couple of things going for him. He plays with Scott Stevens when Stevens is healthy. Last year he did in the playoffs. And he also has Marty Brodeur to move the puck and keep him from getting hit.
Very good point. You don't get you don't go back for the puck with Brodeur. You actually get open.
Joe Sakic has a goal and three here tonight. A four-point night in an eight-goal game for his team and counting with lots of time left in the third period. Marcus Naslin after the puck against John Michael Lyles threw it out front, knocked away by Nikolishin. Here's Brian Allen. Takes a shot. That went up high and off the glass, missing the net on a deflection. Brian Allen off the boards. Morrison advances the puck. Todd Bertuzzi spins and deals for Marcus Naslin. He's tied up by Connor Walchuk. They rough it up a little bit as the puck is cleared down the ice. The stars on both teams have become targets here tonight, and it all goes back to the Steve Moore hit on Marcus Naslin. In the tried and true tested law of the league, you don't necessarily go after Steve Moore, although that has happened tonight. But you go after the top players on the other team, not to injure them, but to hit them and hit them and hit them again so that they get mad at Steve Moore, and that's how you keep the underlings in line in the NHL.
It's true, and it's especially the way it used to be.
And sometimes it doesn't happen anymore.
Now Brookbank comes in.
And he wants Peter Worrell.
Peter Worrell had a hold of Jarkko Ruutu, and Brookbank came in and grabbed Worrell. How are they going to... Okay, so Brookbank's got a penalty. Is that the only penalty?
Maybe. Kurt Sauer starts into this fray. Rutu's in the middle of it. Worrell's got a hold of him, and in comes Wade Brookbank with a face wash. And a pick me, please. Only penalty is going to be to Brookbank. Unless there's some misconducts here as well. Ruutu's being ushered off the ice. Let's join Dan.
Watch future Sportsnet Pacific telecasts and you'll win not a face wash from Wade Brookbank, but perhaps a week-long all-inclusive trip for two to the Holiday Inn Port of Arta, courtesy of Sunquest Vacations and Holiday Inn Port of Arta. Shop and swipe at Safeway, and you could be our next lucky winner.
Brookbank, the only man to get a penalty here.
Yeah, it was interesting. It was Jarkko Ruutu that was over at the penalty box and then was ushered out.
They told him he couldn't have the penalty.
Exactly. That doesn't happen often.
Only one penalty. I thought maybe Ruutu was being ushered back to the bench because it had a misconduct, but that's not the case. An eighth power play for the Colorado Avalanche. They've scored on two of them. Nikolishin. Out with Tamu Solani and Paul Kariya. Tony Granato just going to play the heck out of Solani on the power play and try and get him going. He hasn't got a point in 11 games. They really need his offense. They really need him to start playing like the Finnish Flash. Here he is to the net with a pass to Kariya, intercepted by Salo. He's tracked down by Kariya, so he turns back, kills some time in the penalty to Wade Brookbank, sees the Avalanche on a change, and he wires a shot in off the glass. Abisher lost his stick trying to control the puck. Scratched it. Alex Tange with Darby Henriksen. Scratched kept the puck into the line. Brent Sopel to Brian Allen. And he shoots the puck the length of the ice. 50 seconds to go in the penalty to Brookbank.
Tony Granato giving big Peter Worrell a little bit of a confidence builder. He puts him out in the power play. I guess as a little reward for what he's done tonight.
He's with Darby Henriksen. Alex Tange. Worrell goes to the front of the net. Foot's open back at the right point. The pass comes to him. Worrell's cross-checked down by Sopel as Henriksen put a shot up over top of the net. Now Hedberg took a whack at Peter Worrell, and the fans applaud that. Jarkko Ruutu shorthanded with a shot at David Abisher. There have now been 20 shots by Vancouver at David Abisher, 16 with the puck. Milan Hayduk to Derek Morris. Matthias Olin is back for the puck. 7.5 minutes into this third period, 8-2 Avalanche. They're now 2-for-8 with the man advantage as Brookbank's penalties expired. Sakic. And out for players like Joe Sakic and Milan Hayduk and Alex Tanguay, they just can't get this one over fast enough. I think there's an awful lot of players in the game in that same mindset.
I agree. I think the only players that really want to be there is Kariya and Solani. And not that they want to be in the game like this, but they want to get their offense started.
Brent Sopel kicks the puck into Todd Bertuzzi. Allen's got a piece of, looks like one of those fasteners for his shin guards came off. Thought he was going to step on it there for a moment. Sean Pronger pushing and shoving Steve Moore. Steve hasn't had a shift for a while, so nobody's been after him. Todd Bertuzzi after Steve Moore. Grabs his shoulder, having a little chat with him, grabs his sweater, gives him a whack, and piling on is Andrei Nikolishin, and everybody's into it. Now we got a line brawl, and Hedberg wants Abisher. Johan Hedberg comes to center, and he invites Abisher, who points to the clock, and the score. Kurt Sauer being roughed up by Brad May. Oh, May just hit Kurt Sauer hard with a left hand.
Oh, Steve Moore's hurt really bad. Moore's head went into the ice.
And now they need a trainer on the ice in a hurry here. And the Vancouver trainer comes on quickly, and they need more than just the trainers. They're calling for medical help for Steve Moore. Steve Moore down in the pileup at center ice. An incensed Colorado bench. And the score settling has gone too far. Is moving his legs. It looked like he tried to get up, and they just told him to stay down here.
Yep.
While we step out and take a break. 8-2, the Avalanche lead.
When the Coors Light Brewing Company puts its mind to something, we follow through. You said you wanted a beer that would be ice cold. Done. You said you wanted a beer with an easy drinking taste. So be it. You said you wanted to meet those girls over there.
You can do that?
Hey, we make beer, not miracles. Coors Light, the silver bullet.
Every day, you get a fresh start at life.
Start fresh every day. With a smile, I'm on my way.
Start your day fresh with breakfast at Subway. Egg sandwiches made fresh with no greasy taste on fresh baked bread. Your choice of bacon, ham, western, or cheese, plus your favorite Subway toppings.
Start fresh every day. Subway, start fresh.
As Jack Bauer, I've learned a lot of spy lingo. In the next 24 seconds, I'll teach you another language. Ready? The one-timer, shooting the puck without stopping it. Between the pipes is where the goalie plays. Between his legs is the five-hole. Above the five-hole, a cup. Not that one. This is a twig. That is a biscuit. Top shelf is a goal score just underneath the crossbar. So now when you hear someone say, I snapped my twig on a one-timer, tried to go top shelf, but the biscuit found the five-hole, you'll get it.
Colorado Avalanche forward Steve Moore lies on the ice getting lots of medical attention here and will be carried off when they can stabilize things on the ice.
Yeah, the face of Steve Moore, his head goes down here. Bertuzzi goes after him, and he lands on him right there. And then the pile lands on Steve Moore. Looks like he's out at that point.
Another look at it. Bertuzzi wanted him. Piled on him, and you can see that his head hits the ice and everyone else piles on, and that doesn't help. And that's likely to cost Todd Bertuzzi. The fans in this building all standing.
Yeah.
And quietly watching the scene.
At this point, you're just hoping that Steve Moore is all right.
Now, retribution was wanted for the hit on Marcus Naslund, but I can guarantee you that no one, not even Todd Bertuzzi, wanted this result.
Agreed. This has been a very weird game. This game has got out of hand in a number of ways.
It began with a record number of goals in a short order for the Colorado Avalanche, 4. In a minute and 39 seconds in the first period to open up a 5-0 lead. And at that point, Vancouver decided to start settling some old scores. There were some running at Moore. There were some hits on the top players. There was some challenging, the goading of the goaltender, David Abisher. And Marcus Naslund, who a couple of weeks ago was lying on the ice and had to be helped from it in Colorado, I'm sure has some concern here as he watches Steve Moore being attended to, all of these players do. We step out again and hope for the best for Steve Moore.
The beauty of the suit is that the bottoms match the top. So all you have to do is throw on a shirt and tie and you're out the door. You get to work earlier, your productivity goes up, you get a bigger bonus, put the kids in better schools, they get better jobs, make tons of money, buy you a home to retire to on an island. No wonder suits are coming back. Suits starting at just $150. Well made, well priced, well dressed. Moore's.
This week in Thunder Bay, Ontario, a hero was born. Murphy posted 25 saves and 8-2 pucks to lead his team to victory in this year's Clark Street Cup. Pretty good for a 3-year-old.
Backyard hockey is more than a game, and the Home Depot is more than a store, which is why we're proud to help build rinks in communities and backyards all across Canada.
Former captain of the Harvard Crimson, the Windsor, Ontario native Steve Moore of the Colorado Avalanche is being taken from the ice. With lots of great medical attention around him, looking after him here. After an ugly incident at General Motors Place in Vancouver in an 8-2 game with the Colorado Avalanche leading. A game that meant so much for both teams in the standings that one wouldn't have predicted anything like this, but it got out of hand in the score early, so score settling started, and it's ended with this ugly incident and Todd Bertuzzi out of the game with a 5-minute penalty showing on the scoreboard. And I would think with 11 minutes and 19 seconds to go in the third period, that should put an end to the incidents.
Tony Granato just having a chat with Peter Worrell and others, just basically telling them that's it. Let's get this game done. I would agree with you, though, Jim. As much as this got aggressive as a game, There's nobody on that ice on either team that would ever have envisioned or wanted what happened to Steve Moore.
No, it just went a little too far. And there is a certain amount to be said for the way that some scores are settled in the NHL by the hard hitting against opponents' top players. You don't go to injure someone, you go after them, you go hard hitting. You make them understand that the top players aren't to be trifled with. And then it was Bertuzzi who wanted to settle a score for his linemate and good friend Marcus Naslund that went after Steve Moore. And he wanted to send him a message, but I don't think this is the message Bertuzzi wanted to send him.
Oh, great. So Johan Hedberg also received a minor for leaving the crease and coming to center ice. And it was Bertuzzi at the end of a shift that suckers Moore and then takes him straight down. And it was everybody piling on that may have hurt him just as bad.
That just made the situation worse, didn't it? Hedberg left his crease to try and entice David Abisher into a scrap. Abisher at an 8-2 game wisely said no thanks. And now there is a very subdued atmosphere everywhere in this building as this game between Colorado and Vancouver continues. And they can blow the horn and send everybody home, and I don't think anybody would now care.
Agreed. 11 minutes and 19 seconds to go in the third period.
Play will continue with the Avalanche on a 5-on-3. Their ninth power play of the game. Hedberg almost had his pocket picked. Now the Avalanche do get the puck back in the 5-on-3. Here's Derek Morris with John Michael Lyles. Screen being set up in front of the net by Dan Heino. Lyles with a shot just wide of the net. Salo to Mike Keane. And he finds an opening and sends the puck down the ice, and the penalty killers will change up. Lyles to Hajdu. John Michael Lyles. Connor Walchuk goes to the front of the net. Derek Morris with the puck. Cross ice pass tipped wide by Milan Hajdu. Morris to Lyles. Lyles with a pass to Hajdu in front of the net for Connor Walchuk. Stop. Rebound shot off the post by Alex Tangay. 5-on-3 continues for 50 more seconds at least. Or at most. Tange. Quick shot by Hajduk and he couldn't finish it. Lyles. Hedberg lost his stick, gets it back. Hajduk shot. And a broken stick is discarded as the puck gets out of play. The penalties meted out, you knew there were some fighting majors in there to Brad May, who has his third fighting major of the night, and Kurt Sauer.
There's
a save by Hedberg.
Yeah, good save right here. Oh, it goes off of Brian Allen, right off the elbow.
Off the right post of Brian Allen.
Yeah, it did.
Amongst those penalties, a match penalty to Todd Bertuzzi. Three seconds left in the penalty to Hedberg, being served by Pronger or Henrik Sedin. Those are the two Vancouver Canucks in the penalty box, serving the penalties to Bertuzzi and to Hedberg. Joe Sakic with a 4-point night, a goal and three to Paul Kariya. Passes off to Riku Hall. Sakic across the random foot, couldn't pull the trigger. Tried the one-timer, couldn't get it away. Kariya again. He's got Sakic and Solani with him. Foot and Riku Hall. Ryan Allen trying to clear the puck. One penalty's expired. Henrik Sedin has come back on after serving the penalty to Hedberg. Sean Pronger continues to sit for Bertuzzi. 2 minutes and 52 seconds remain in the 5-minute penalty. That's the part of the match being served by Pronger for Bertuzzi. John Michael Lyles
Big Peter Worrell, Jimmy's on the ice, and so Wade Brookbank's on the ice.
They bump shoulders. Brookbank's got some spirit for this. I'm not sure that Peter Worrell has any.
Well, Worrell went over and gave him a shoulder, you know. Then he didn't want to do it. He's 1 penalty.
Looks like perhaps just Brookbank. That wasn't necessarily the case here. They did bump shoulders, as you pointed out. And Brookbank looked like he was ready and eager at the start of it. Then get wrapped up by Brookbank. Only the 1 penalty.
This might be one of the ways that both referees want to try to keep things under control, too.
So back onto the 5-on-3 for the Colorado Avalanche. For a couple of minutes, 4 minutes to Brookbank. He gets a double minor. So this will set up a 2-minute 5-on-3 that could only serve to pad the stats of the Colorado Avalanche, already leading here 8-2. Ilan Hadou. Tanguay, his shot was stopped by Hedberg. John Michael Lyles took a shot. Hedberg made the save as Olin stumbled. The rebound is loose, poked in by Hadou, and he's got his third. A hat trick for Ilan Hadou against his favorite team to play against, and he's up to 35 of the season.
Yeah, this is just to bump it in. He's on a 5-on-3. Hadouk's off the side of the crease, and he's just able to bump this puck over top of the stick of Hedberg. So there's the shot. Little play there. Good little pass there. And Hadouk just bumps it in.
This is after Matthias Olenrein had stumbled and fallen in front of the net. So there's wide open men at the side of the goal. Already 5-on-3. And then Olin's right out of the play. And the 5-on-3 continues. As one of the minors to Brookbank expires and the other one starts to tick away. Hadouk from Tanguay and John Michael Lyles. Morel gets some 5-on-3 power play time. Bumped into Mike Keane. Here's Paul Kariya. Morel screening in front. Adam Foote with a shot that hit Mike Keane. And Foote might get another shot at it. Morel battling Brent Sokol in front. Paul Kariya. Connor Walchuk to Kariya. Morel is an imposing figure in front of the net. Kariya faked the shot. Passes back to Foote. Kariya, Foote takes the shot. Connor Walchuk trying to stuff it in. Hedberg stopped it. Sopel to Keane and down the ice and onto the Vancouver bench.
Whether we work on your car or you do it yourself, we have quality auto parts at the right price at Canadian Tire.
Peter Worrell getting some power play time here, and he's tough to move.
Yeah, he is. Brent Sopel and Worrell really went at it here. Sopel's wondering, how do you move that mountain of a man? The big guy.
Here's Derek Morris. John Michael Lyles. Darby Hendrickson to Lyles, shot the puck just wide of the net. Salani trying to stuff the puck in, and he couldn't beat Hedberg, and there's a whistle from Dennis Leroux, who lost sight of the puck. With 20 seconds to go in this latest 5-on-3, I think it's the fourth 5-on-3 that the Avalanche have had in the game.
Timo Salani still shaking his head, was unable to pop that puck past Hedberg. And you're right, if there's one player that Tony Granato desires to have him get going and get his offense going, it's Timo Salani. Looks like the trainer giving Tony Granato a bit of an update on Steve Moore.
Well, we all hope that it's good news. Worrell continues to screen in front. Hedberg makes a save on Dan Hyno. And as this game goes on, I know Vancouver fans are probably watching and thinking, what are the implications of this? What are the implications of a 9-2 loss to the Avalanche this late in the season in a game that means so much? What are the implications of Todd Bertuzzi and the match penalty? You know that this will be visited by the NHL. Bertuzzi, a couple of years ago, was suspended 10 games for coming off the bench to fight Scott Parker against the Colorado Avalanche.
Right.
He could face a suspension. There's a trading deadline tomorrow. There's a battle for first in the Northwest Division.
And only 14 games left for both these teams.
And this is an incident that the NHL could come down very hard on. Trevor Linden to Matt Cook. Teams are 5-on-5 here. 13 power plays for the Avalanche. They're 3-for-13. 4-5-on-3s. And a 9-2 game with the Avalanche leading. Avalanche head for Edmonton tomorrow, where they play the Oilers on Wednesday night. Their biggest win of the season follows their worst loss. And another stop in play with under 5 minutes to go on Molson Canucks Hockey from Vancouver.
Introducing Molson Ultra, the only lower carb beer that's not a light beer. 2.5 grams of carbs, 97 calories, and still brewed full strength. Molson Ultra. Real beer, fewer carbs.
The award-winning Kia Sorento is the midsize SUV people are talking about. It's no surprise with a 5-star safety rating and the best warranty in the business. The Kia Sorento. How far will you go?
When you unwind a Reason, rich, delicious European chocolate covering chewy, chocolatey caramel will unwind you.
And make the world go away.
All you need is one good Reason.
Chevrolet Hockey Poll for Chevrolet for all life's roads. Which Canuck would you most like to see interviewed in a future Sportsnet telecast? A little humor early in the game. 68% Miroslav Chatan, the Buffalo Sabre, who may or may not be on the move. With the deadline coming up tomorrow at noon, watch for all of the trade coverage. Hockey Central crew augmented with some great experts with good analysis. There'll be all sorts of trade talk. Although there have been a million already done, I'm sure there'll be more before the deadline. One tonight, the Colorado Avalanche picked up Matthew Barnaby from the Rangers. They gave up a former first pick in the draft, the young defenseman from the Plymouth Whalers, David Littleton. A stay-at-home defensive-type defenseman. And a pretty good prospect. The Avalanche have been very busy. They're going for it.
Absolutely.
So many teams are.
And it feels like that pressure just can sort of continues to mount on different teams for different reasons. You see the Calgary Flames active just because of what's happened to them. And so for different reasons, teams tend to have pressure. We'll see what happens even here in Vancouver.
Well, I think because the deadline has become such a big deal league-wide, it's televised, it's monitored, it's a competition amongst the networks, there is pressure from fans for their teams to make deals, whether they need them or not.
Todd Bertuzzi's potential suspension. You have to think, as you pointed out, that the NHL will visit something like this. And what does that do to what the Canucks now have to do? Does it change the way they look at the moves they were hoping to make or will make?
Tyler Bug for Vancouver with 3 minutes and 40 seconds to go in this third period. Foote and Sean Pronger battle here. Although the battles have become far less spirited, haven't they?
Sopel to Morrison. Matt Cook lobbed the puck in. David Abisher out of his net to play it. John Michael Lyles off the glass and out. Wade Brookman. Teemu Selänne watching him. There's a hard hit by Worrell on Brookbank. And a good hit, and they just skate away. Here's Worrell. Cook catches up to him and takes him into the boards. Brookbank's hit hard by Nikolishin. And Worrell comes in again. Worrell and Brookbank.
Yeah, this time it's Peter Worrell that's going to get the penalty.
And you can bet Stephen Walker and Dennis LaRue are just looking for a reason to get both of them out of the game here now. Brookbank comes back in and takes a shot at Peter Worrell. Linesman let him go, and now Lonnie Cameron is going to get Brookbank out of there.
Well, what happened there is Worrell got talking to the coaching staff of the Vancouver Canucks. And Brookbank came back at him.
And he was giving the linesman, Mike Civic, a handful. So both Brookbank and Worrell will now go to the penalty box with 2.5 minutes to go in this third period.
Budget Brake and Mufflers having a half price sale. Save one half on Rivestus brake pads and shoes, and one half on Gorlick mufflers. Sale in sale.
Peter Worrell still being restrained here. They're trying to get him out of the game. Mike Civic. It's a good thing it's a big man like Mike that's a linesman tonight here. He's able to at least try and control Peter Worrell. Lonnie Cameron standing there as well in case he's needed. And Worrell's being ushered out of the game here now. And that's it for his night. He was jawing with the Vancouver bench and still has a few parting words. And now he's trying to get at a fan who threw something at him. And he's tough to control now. They didn't have that protection over top in time. And it's stuck.
Now the fan gets ushered out.
Now Rick talking with Lonnie Cameron, having words with the Vancouver bench. My goodness, what a night.
This was a weird game after a period and a half, never mind the 2 minutes and 36 seconds to go in the third.
While this is all going on, there's been yet another deal tonight. Florida has dealt Val Bure to Dallas for prospect Drew Bagnell and a draft pick. So Val Bure on the move tonight from Florida to Dallas. Matthew Barnaby on the move tonight from the Rangers to these Colorado Avalanche.
Wade Brookbank now ushered in by Mike Civic.
They gave him an extra two to get him out of here. Peter Worrell, well, boy, he was a handful. It took all of the security guards and a few of the coaching staff to get Peter Worrell out of here, especially after the fan came down and threw something at him, and the fan has been ushered out of here.
Well, this is just a night to get over. In many ways, it's been an ugly game.
You know what? If it hadn't been for the injury to Steve Moore, we'd have been saying, well, that was just old-time hockey, and making references like that, and okay, all the scores are settled, but that one sends it over the top for me.
Agreed.
Rick Tocchet in his playing days was in a number of these sorts of things. He's been in an awful lot of rough, tough games. Pretty no-nonsense player.
And back in the old days of Philadelphia, he had lots of help, too. So we've got the door open here for the Colorado Avalanche. Nobody in it.
And
nobody's sitting in the penalty benches, but Vancouver is shorthanded here for the 14th time. Oh, no, it's even up. Colorado is shorthanded. Peter Worrell gets the extra penalties. Excuse me. There's the other number 28. Need to be a mathematics professor to calculate here tonight as Baumgartner takes a shot tipped wide. Baumgartner. And a nice save by David Abisher, and he kicks the rebound to the boards. Here's Teemu Selänne out with Andrei Nikolishin in off the wing. Selänne took a shot, and he hooked it wide, and it was deflected up into the netting stopping play. We'll look back on this game in our Kia game review brought to you by Kia. Come out ahead. A record, 4 goals in 1:39 for the Avalanche. That's also a record against for Vancouver. Trevor Linden. Past Stan Smeal tonight, 675 points, and right now doesn't care.
It's a real tough game for that to happen. For Trevor Linden, should have been a game that would allow us fans in Vancouver and broadcasters just to celebrate all that Trevor's done, but that was not going to be.
Daniel Sedin on the power play here with this game mercifully just a minute and a half from coming to a conclusion. Henrik, Brendan Morrison, give and go play. Hedberg sets the puck up for Nolan Baumgartner. Ryan Allen. Backhander and David Abisher steered wide. Sean Pronger. Mike Keane. Bout goes to the front of the net. The pass comes back to the blue line to Brent Sopel. Pronger to Bout. Missed him, and Brian Allen gets the rebound off the boards. John Michael Lyles battles with Mike Keane to get the puck the length of the ice.
This is the line of forwards that very seldom, if maybe ever, get a chance on the power play, but it's again just an indication of the kind of night it's been.
So the Avalanche, even in games with Vancouver, each with 13 to play, will take a 3-point lead atop the Northwest Division. A 9-2 victory is a dozen seconds away from being official, but this game will be revisited for the match penalty issued Todd Bertuzzi for going after Steve Moore. And we'll find out in the days to come the implications it has on the Vancouver Canucks and this playoff race in the Western Conference, with the deadline coming at noon tomorrow.
Well, and the Colorado Avalanche team, Jim, going right into the